Welcome to the Five Letters Podcast, featuring myself, Yells,
alongside Cam,
and yo, it's me, Bez.
Listen, yo, look, I've not got round to reading the Bible, still I'm trying to leave them a worthy example, so I know I've got to get married, it's vital. I was on one knee right under the Eiffel, holding a diamond bigger than a blueberry. When I had a blackberry, it was survival. That meant a flicky went anywhere I go, all cause a rival took shots at me with a rifle. Blood on the tips of my fingers, done a Bruce Lee, then I licked him. Bit off the end of the spliff, then I lit that. I was on a carpet doing crunches, trying to get me a six pack. Dreams of me pushing his wig back, nightmares of me getting 26 in Crown Court. Never been much of a shooter, but I've still bang off. That's the man that I kid, and I know coming all the way through on an attempted Emma. Didn't even do,
did it
got my phone?
1 2 1 2 1 2 Rah, why is my voice so loud? Sorry. Yes, you're locked into the Five Letters Podcast. This is our episode 15. You got myself, Yells, and you got Bez in the building, you got Cam in the building as well. What are you both saying, my guys?
Yo, what's good?
Hello. How is everyone?
I don't know, how are you?
I'm good, man. I'm good. We're getting the drinks thrown today, episode 15. We here in the building.
Back to the roots.
Episode one vibes. I know, episode one with the cover photo of drinks. Yeah, man.
With the edible straws and that.
Edible straws needs to be a thing, like, forever. Like, that was so banging.
Yeah, man. Get rid of these paper straws. Edible straws.
Yeah. I mean, the edible straws that fall apart as well, but at least they're falling apart because they're edible.
They're meant to be falling, yeah.
Like, that makes sense.
Like, paper straw in a milkshake is just the worst thing ever, because by the time you've even got into the drink, it's just, the straw's gone. You can't get anything.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, no, I hear that for real. So how's you lot's 2 weeks been and all of that? What's been popping? What's the vibes, man?
What's it been like these last 2 weeks? So not much has really happened. Just been going to gym again, keeping that going. Went out yesterday.
How was that?
It was all right. It was cold though. It's like, I don't think I could do these drinking outs anymore, man.
You getting too old or too cold?
It's too cold. Maybe because I'm getting old. the blood's not circulating like it used to.
Summer's coming soon though, so.
Yeah, true. But by then, hopefully we can be inside, because the outdoors was, oh my God. Because we got there about 9 o'clock maybe, and there was a long queue already, because obviously everything's tabled. And they had no tables spare, so had to queue up. Was waiting in the queue for about maybe 30 minutes to an hour, and it was chapping. It was like, our teeth were shattering, all sorts. And then went in. It was a nice little vibe inside, like, yeah. Tricky getting a table and all that kind of stuff, like a nice one. It was right by the door and stuff like that, but then they moved us late eventually. But yeah, it's just cold. It's very cold out, and I don't know. I don't think I can hack these harsh winters.
It's the 1st of May. Harsh winters. It's been spring for a while.
It's almost summer. It's literally almost summer.
I know. It's basically summer, but like May is something. No, May's end of spring, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, but it felt like a harsh winter. Like, when once it gets past like 10 o'clock, it gets so cold these days. I don't know why, but.
But this is why you need to go out earlier. Like, if you're going to be out during the day, you need to be doing the early thing. You can't be doing
that.
That's true.
Maybe we should do like a brunch or something.
Yeah. Or you can eat brunch and then, yeah, get the drinks going.
Bottomless brunch.
Bottomless brunch.
It's basically like, Yells will be a fan of this. You get a lot of Prosecco.
it's really a gal thing.
It's a gal thing. They spend, you get like 2 hours where you just get to drink bottomless drink, so you get like Prosecco, you get like cocktails and stuff, and just keep refilling them. And I think they give you like dead pizza and dead like kind of snacky foods as well at the time, but you get drinks to float on tap basically.
Vibes. Sounds like it does sound like a good time, like, as long as you got the right company and all that.
Yeah.
But yeah. What else did you have popping for the week? Or the 2 weeks.
Yeah, man, this has been it really. And then obviously work, just been busy. Looking forward to just having a bit of a longer weekend this week, which is nice to rest, get some rest.
I've been looking for holiday vibes.
Yeah, man. I've been looking for new cars, so that's what I've been kind of doing in my spare time.
Trying to upgrade the whip, yeah.
Upgrade the whip, man. Needed.
So you're getting that Phantom.
Getting the Phantom. Yeah. Panda. Cruising panda. Look like a panda.
Yeah. I hear it. But yeah, what about you, Cam, man? What are you saying? Talk to me.
I swear to God, but every time I come on this podcast, I must sound the most boring guy. Because I never do anything. I just, I watch things. I play games. I sit at home.
Well,
to be fair, we're in lockdown.
We're in lockdown. And yeah, we'll be getting into those things later anyway as well.
Yeah. But yeah, that's it really. I mean, I've seen a few new things that I'm going to talk about later on. When we get into the what we've been watching section.
Actually, do you know what? This is episode 15, right? And this is like a milestone. Let's just throw caution to the wind and let's just mix things up entirely. What have you been watching? Talk to us now.
Ooh.
Let's go. Straight away.
Ooh.
I know, yeah, I've spoken to you about this. Yeah, I know you haven't seen it yet, but Invincible. Bez, you know about this one?
I've seen it on Prime, but I ain't watched it yet.
Yeah. It's a wild one. Must watch, 100%.
That's a big recommendation.
We're all comic book fans. We're all superhero heads. Like, this is the vibe. It's just, it's like The Boys, but animated.
Okay, because it's 18 or something, isn't it? As well, yeah. That's so I got that kind of vibe from it. So I was like, it might be good, but I just haven't had the chance to watch it yet.
Yeah, I need
the last episode dropped yesterday.
Oh, the whole season's finished.
Oh,
okay.
And it's got renewed for season 2 and 3. So,
jeez, you know,
this stuff.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's mad. I need to watch. Like, I've been seeing people talking about it on Twitter and stuff.
Yeah.
And yeah, they've been gassing. And obviously, I've spoken to you about it, Cam. But yeah, I haven't seen any like trailers or anything. I need to like.
Don't watch any trailers I watched a trailer that was on Amazon Prime after I'd finished the show,
mm-hmm.
and I was like, there's so many things in the trailer that would spoil it for you. Like, you'll see stuff coming that you don't need to see coming.
Right, okay.
It's like, you should just
go in as blind as possible.
Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, nah, from what I've heard about it, from what, like, obviously you said and stuff like that, it's definitely, like, one of the things on my list that I'm like, yeah, nah, I need to get around to watching this at some point. Once I finish with what I'm currently watching.
How many episodes are there in season 1?
There's 8 episodes.
And are they 20-minute episodes?
They're like 25-minute maybe.
Okay, that's really short then.
Yeah. But it's to the point, you know?
Yeah.
It's to the point. Okay. Gets everything done.
Yeah, I can bang that out over this weekend.
Yeah, literally, I started watching it because I saw, like, someone did a skit on YouTube, like, just memeing on one of the characters in the show. And I was like, I don't get the skit, but it seems that the show could be good to watch. Mm-hmm. So I started watching it on that day, which was Wednesday, I think. And then, so on Wednesday, I watched episode 1. And then Thursday, I watched 2 to 7. And then Friday, I watched episode 8.
Okay.
Luckily, I started watching it when the last episode was about to come out. So I was like, yes, cool.
Good timing.
Yeah, it's a banger. It's definitely a banger. And then I just binged another show as well. It's... on Netflix, the Dota animation show.
I saw when that came out.
The game, yeah. I heard a while back that it was good, and I was like, it should be interesting based on, like, because it is the type of game, like, the type of game that it is, it should interest me if it's just a storyline from the game. And, yeah, it was good. It was... I binged it, but I wasn't paying attention that much because I was doing other things at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
But the general gist was I really enjoyed it. And yeah, I'm waiting for the next season to drop, whenever that is planned to drop and whatnot. And then I just started Returnal, the game.
The game.
That dropped like sometime last week. And I'm looking forward to playing more of that, hopefully. Play like an hour of it, hour and a half.
Yeah. I mean, it looks really sick. Like, when I saw like the trailers and stuff for that game, I wasn't too keen on it. But from what I've seen since it's dropped, like, gameplay wise and like reviews and stuff, it is sounding quite sick. So I think I'm gonna give that a go as well.
Have you Bez, have you played any games like The Binding of Isaac, or like any games where you enter into the game and then if you die you have to start from the beginning again, like with So that's pretty much what it is.
Oh man,
you go into it and then if you die you're going back to where you started with, like, you start off with just a pistol.
Oh my god,
going through the dungeon, like whatever, doing picking up like upgrades to your armor, your health, your guns, and yeah, whatever. If you die, it's peak. You go back to that pistol.
Oh my god.
But they do have like permanent upgrades as well, so you can carry stuff over certain things. But yeah,
that's, do you get like skills and stuff and like level up kind of things like, so that doesn't start again? Or
it depends, like certain things you can get that will be a permanent upgrade,
yeah,
and other things you have to go again and find out.
I'll be so furious because some games sometimes when you die it's actually like
dying dumb ways as well.
I died and the annoying thing is that the game is really dark, so I just walked off the edge. I didn't even clock there was an edge there. I just walked off and died and I had to start again. I was like, okay, cool.
Is it because I played like, so, there's one game, I can't remember what it was, but when you die, you can pick up your stuff still. Even if you, even though you lose everything, you can still go back and pick it up. But is it like that or it's
like
gone?
That sounds like Minecraft.
Yeah, it's like.
Yeah, Minecraft is one.
It's like you die and then everything that you've done already, like it all changes. So the rooms that you see are all different.
Oh, man.
So you can't even go back and find your old body because it's all changed.
Wait, it changes?
Yeah, it changes. So it's
like, okay, that's interesting. At least it's not like you're repeating it all sort of thing.
You don't have to, you don't just go again from the same position. Because if it was that, it would be like simple.
But yeah.
Yeah. And then like one time I just randomly dropped into a boss that I didn't know was there. I just was like just walking along and then I opened the door and then I step in and there's a boss there and he just kills me one shot. And I'm like, okay, well. But yeah, I like games like that, but generally they're usually like 2D games, like kind of bullet hell kind of games.
Yeah.
But this is a different take. It's quite interesting.
Yeah, no, I'm definitely going to indulge at some point, see what it's saying, man, see what the vibe is. But honestly, since we're here, yeah, let's just flip this episode on its head. Episode 15, breaking all the rules. Bez, man, what you been watching? What you been playing? What's going on?
Okay. What am I watching? So I've finished Vampire Diaries. I was watching that last episode and I just finished that now.
Yeah.
Have you seen all of it before?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, and so I just rewatched it all.
Eight before.
Yeah.
Season 8,
yeah. It wasn't great, but
I stopped after season 7.
It went so downhill. Like, the only thing is, like, obviously Elena, spoiler, like, I'm going to say minus spoilers, but Elena, I didn't like her throughout, and then obviously things happened and et cetera, et cetera.
Honestly, it's been so long we could talk about it.
Well, she disappeared, and then I wasn't missing her, but the show went downhill even when she left. I was like, I thought I would have thought it'd be better when she's not there, sort of thing.
She carried, like, it's weird, but she kind of carried the show.
Yeah, literally.
Like, as annoying as she was at times, she kind of carried the show.
She was, she was the focal point. Like, without her, it just kind of all lost all transition, and yeah, it was a bit of a mess. But it was an okay show. Like, from start to like season 6, it was sick. But then from there on, it went downhill. And then started the originals, just because you have to when you finish Vampire Diaries. I'm watching that now.
You lot are nerds.
What are you talking about, man?
Okay.
I'm just letting everyone know, innit?
You're a nerd too.
That, but you are worse nerds.
Why?
There's no such thing.
Nah, Vampire Diaries ain't it.
What do you mean it's not? Have you seen it?
I don't need to see it to know it ain't it.
How do you know?
This is the same way I knew that, I was going to say Hawkeye. What's the guy's name?
Winter Soldier and Falcon.
Winter Soldier and Falcon. That's how I knew from before even seeing that weren't going to be it either. And this is what I'm saying. Vampire Diaries ain't it. But
Vampire Diaries is it. Vampire Diaries is good.
No. You lot continue having your conversation. Enjoy. But I'm just letting the people know you man are nerds, innit?
All right. Well, watch it and then come back and let's see.
Sorry.
And the originals is better than Vampire Diaries as well. But originals is sick. So I'm watching that now. And that's it, really. I haven't been watching anything else. And then playing, I finally got Assassin's Creed, so I've been playing that. So that's a fun game. It's very brutal, very gory, and just it's very violent. That's one thing I'll say about it. So if you're under 18, don't play it.
Is it more violent than the other ones?
Yeah, because you like chop people's heads off at night in this one. It's proper brutal. But apparently, and then they got like cinematics in it, so when you can parry someone, they do like a stun attack where they're down and you can just kind of finish them, and then apparently they've taken like the cinematics out for that because people were complaining that it was too much. But I'm kind of watching it, it's like I'm loving it. I just, like, every single one I feel like it's just brutal, it's mad.
Where's it set?
England.
What, like, time period?
Viking times. So, it's funny because obviously they have the places. So it's like you have Cambridgeshire, but it's called like Gannickshire or something. Then you got London, but it's called something else. And so you got the areas, but it's just, it's, they've changed the names a bit. So I'm in like Leicestershire now, which is basically Leicester. And if you look at the map, it's basically, it's England. So it's pretty good. And you come from, I think it's Norway or something. Yeah, or Finland, one of those two.
Oh yeah, Vikings, that kind of area.
Yeah, so you come from there
as a Viking.
Yeah, oh, I see. And you choose your character if you want to be a man or woman, and then
wait, you choose your character.
Yeah,
is that's something new? Or
they did it in the last one
sure,
as well.
Yeah, sure.
That's, you can choose a man or woman. So similar, you can choose man or woman, but you don't create them. You just choose man or woman, or you can let the game choose for you, which I don't know what the point of that is, but it's a fun game though. I'm enjoying that, and yeah, that's it about it for me.
Scene. Well, obviously, I'm still watching Castle, almost finished. Obviously, yeah, I've been speaking about that in the last few podcasts. At the moment, I'm also been watching Temptation Island.
Oh my God! Where are you watching it? On Channel 4?
Nah. I'm just using a bootleg site.
Oh, you need to send me the link, because I was looking for episodes of that.
Vlad, this show is effed. Like, it is so messed up. It's unbelievable. Like, I don't know if you lot saw, but there was a clip going around on Twitter.
I saw that.
Like, a couple of days ago. Cam's looking at me like he didn't see. I didn't think he would see, to be fair. But it was... Well, Cam, let me explain the premise to you so you kind of understand, right? So, four couples go away on this island, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then the whole point is they want to see if their relationship is, you know, strong, if they've got their strong bond, if they're meant to be together, like all of these kind of things, right? So in order to do that, this is why it's called Temptation Island, you got the four guys, they go live in one house, the four girls, they go live in another house, and with the four girls are 12 men, single men, and with the four guys is 12 single women. And the whole point of the singles is that they're trying to find love, and they pretty much actively pursue the people in relationships. They go on dates, they like have parties together, drink alcohol, like all of these kind of like social things. And the whole thing is about, you're meant to like
resist the temptation
and like stay faithful to your partner or not. Maybe you find someone in the house on the island that you feel like you connect with better than your partner, and in which case you go for it. So the clip that was floating around on Twitter was of, all right, and then also to kind of like explain as well, so then what happens is the partners get to kind of check up on each other. So they have like these bonfires where they go away and they just see like clips of their partner, just little out of context clips of their partner and what they've been getting up to. And it's so bad because the clips are so out of context sometimes, like that it looks worse than what it was.
It's fully stirring the pot,
like being. And then the host is so bad as well, because he'll be like, so how does that make you feel? That like, you see what she's doing. Yeah, does that hurt? So the clip that was going around on Twitter was of this guy obviously seeing his girl getting basically digged
out.
Yeah, she was just in the bed. She's in the bed with the guy, and he's like, "Oh, no!" And he's like punching the ground, like he gets so mad. So I saw that clip, and I was like, "I need to find out what this
is
show
it real."
What do you mean is real?
Is that clip real?
That's what happened. So the first clip was him and was the guy's girlfriend kissing and the guy. Mm-hmm. And then they saw that and they're like, and then the next clip was him and the girl in bed together. And it was, yeah, the guy's the hair crying, like wiping his eyes. It starts punching the floor.
Yeah, it was rough.
What happened after that with that couple?
So that's literally where I'm at the moment, because I'm watching that season. So that's literally where I'm at. But
so that's like the latest episode.
No. Oh. So I'm like a season behind. The season that's going on now is another one. But I wanted to watch that season in particular because I wanted to see what happened with that clip.
Yeah.
But one thing I can say, and spoilers, sorry, they didn't even have sex. So the clip is set up to make it look like they were having sex, right? To show the guy, so the guy, to get the reaction from the guy. And obviously the guy is going to go and move mad now because he thinks he's seen his girl having sex. But they didn't have sex. They were just lipsing and they were getting really close in the bed and whatever, but they didn't do anything.
They did enough.
They definitely did enough. That's definitely a problem. Like, that would be a problem in a relationship, but they didn't go all the way.
Yeah.
But the clip made it look like they were going all the way. Like, yeah, the show is mad. But yeah, Cameron, what is this? What's your take on the show anyway, man?
If you go on the show, you have no right to be annoyed if your partner does anything.
Why? The whole point is you're meant to be proven to each other.
Because you decided to go and put yourself in that situation. Like, you didn't have to.
There must be money or something to win at the end of it. No, it's just a test.
No mention of any money.
Oh, okay.
The victory comes with within your relationship intact. Yeah,
Stays in the place the whole time. Or
you stay there for a month.
So all the couples stay no matter what happens.
Yeah, the singles get voted off. Like, so, yeah, the four guys will vote off like the girls every now, like some of the girls every now and again, and the four girls will vote off some of the guys every now and again. And the point is, I guess, is to force them to try and make connections with like one or two of the guys, and then they just slim down, you know, the herd.
That is, I think the premise is stupid. I think
it's outrageous.
I think
I love it.
I don't know why you would want to put yourself in that situation, like. Either you're a strong couple, so you don't need to do that. You don't need to test each other like that.
Yeah.
Or you're weak and going on the show means you're just giving the other person permission to go and do something, and then you're just gonna get mad about it on TV. Like, what for? Is this British or American?
I think it's American. Or
it's definitely American. Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's the worst. It sounds like the worst premise for a reality TV show that I've heard.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
It's so messy. Like, I was just so curious. I had to watch it. And then just every episode, my jaw is just on the ground. It's just messy. Like, the whole show, like, all right, so Love Island and that.
You,
like,
you know what? You're actually turning into a reality, don't you?
I'm not.
The last few episodes, so you've watched The Circle.
Circle was sick, though.
Reality show. You watched this Temptation Island. What other ones have you watched now? Love Island, you watched that before?
I watched half a season of Love Island once just to see what the crack was.
You're turning into a rally though.
No, I'm not.
X on the beach next time you'll be here watching this.
No. All right. So The Circle, I watched The Circle because The Circle has an interesting concept. So I like The Circle, I can admit that much. Love Island, I'll never watch that again.
Yeah.
And this, I think after I finish this season, I'll probably never watch it again as well, because it's too much. It's actually too much. Like, I'm watching it and I'm seeing the stuff that they're going through and like all the tears that's being shed and all of this. And I'm like, yo, like, on the one hand, I kind of want to blame them because I'm like, okay, you chose to go in the show, like you knew what you're signing up for. But on the other hand, you didn't know what you're signing up for because
they're going to be loyal.
Yeah, and the way the show just stirs the pot, like you think you go on thinking, I know I'm going to be low and my partner's going to be low because I know my partner.
Yeah.
But then the way the show will just show, like, they show you out all these out of context clips of like your partner saying like something like
outrageous.
It's not even something outrageous. Like one girl was asked by a girl if he thinks his girl is the one, and he said, I can't answer that definitively as a yes, but like I love her so much, like XYZ, like
good answer.
That's exactly what they did.
So she was fuming now when she saw that clip, because she was like, how can he say that?
I can't definitely say yes, and that's it.
That's all they showed. They didn't show the part where he explained how he like feels about her, like overall. It was just the, you know, she was like, no, he's so casually just saying, oh, he doesn't know that. Da, da, da. And then so then she goes back to these 12 dudes now.
Choo choo.
Do they get to see the clips that are shown like on the other side of the situation? Like, do the boys get to see what clips are shown to the girls of them?
No.
peak.
So they're just living, so on both sides, they're just living their life, and they can sometimes kind of imagine, like, when they've done something particularly bad. So like some of the people have kissed like people and done that other things, like the girl that was in the bed with the guy. The reason why we know she didn't have sex was because she said to one of the other girls, she was like, I know they're gonna show my boyfriend that clip, but it's all right. He didn't go all the way. So that's how we know that she didn't go all the way. But the way the show showed it to him,
they went all the way.
They don't get to talk to each other until the end.
They have no communication. And this is why I said the clips.
I hope they all four couples that go on the show just break up, because
right now that's what it's looking like. Because it's the clips are just escalating. And it's just like, okay, that how you going to do? Okay, then what? This is what I'm going to do. Like, I'm gonna
go
back.
About to go now.
that already shows that, even if people were cheating on you, like, it's not a revenge thing. Like, just live life, man.
When you're in the moment, yeah, and you've got
12 hot girls like trying to throw themselves at you, basically.
And that's literally what it is, like. All the guys have like at least one or two girls that are on them. All the girls have at least one or two guys that are on them. Like,
yeah, like strength.
What's it called?
Strength.
What? Temptation Island.
Temptation Island, I see.
And then you see your girl hooking up in bed with another man, and they're just like, nah.
You just gotta go find your bed and go
cry.
Have a good cry.
No, but then, yeah, you do.
And
that.
Then the girl comes in and like rubs your back when you're crying, and they put that clip to them, and then.
That's literally it. Like, you'll be crying, yeah, in bed, and then someone's like, no, but you're meant to be here and you're having fun, don't worry about her, like, come have a drink, like, come outside.
Oh, this is trash.
We're having a party, like, come outside.
How can the singles feel good about this?
Because they're there to find love, isn't it?
No,
they
wanna, you don't find love with someone who's it's in true. A relationship.
That's what you're like,
to steal your girl.
Exactly.
It's so bad.
If he's cheating on his girl for you, then the relationship is looking techie already from there. But
I think the end of the I think the couples either have to stay. I think the challenge is that you either stay for the whole month and you go home with together, or alternatively, you can leave with one of the singles early.
Yeah.
So
I feel like if your partner suggests to you that you should go on this show, they're saying to you that I'm trying to look for someone else, but I'm too lazy to break up with you. So go on this show and I'm going to find someone and then I'm going to peace out.
And if I don't, then I'll stick with you because I can't find anything else right now.
Nah. I mean, there's that, but there was a lot of the reasoning was, oh,
we're bored.
Nah, it was, oh, my girl doesn't trust me. She doesn't believe what I say. Da, da, da. So this is my opportunity to prove to her like what I'm like when she's not around. That I'm still loyal, like XYZ, XYZ, XYZ.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it was a way for like some, because that's pretty much what it is in all the relationship. It was either A, the woman has trust issues. So it's, yeah, let me prove your trust issues are like not warranted. Or B, the woman doesn't think that he's serious about her or whatever. Like, these kind of things. For some reason, it's always the woman that has issues. The guy's like, yeah, let's go in this Temptation Island and, like, just blow these issues up, like, for the whole world to see. But, yeah, nah, it's absolutely bonkers. But I'm enjoying it. But at the same time, I hate it. I feel like the show should get cancelled because it's so bad.
I feel like that's what reality shows are like. It's like you enjoy it, but you hate it. It's like the way they film it, edit it, and everything, put it together, it's done so well that it just makes you, it leaves you hanging for wanting more. You're like, what's happening next episode? I have to watch it because the end of, like, so that episode where they showed the guy punching the floor, that even in the clip on Twitter, that ended there.
Yeah.
So it's like, I need to see what happens next, sort of thing. And it's just, yeah. It's a joke. I love reality shows, man.
I hate them. I legitimately hate them. And I think this one is particularly egregious because, yeah, this concept is effed.
Yeah, I don't mind reality shows if they're, like, obviously ones that are not relationship-based. Like, obviously, The Apprentice is sick. All the cooking shows are sick. Like, all the Gordon Ramsay reality shows are sick. But these relationship ones are just silly. I'm like, why would you go on this? Like, okay, if it's ones that are people trying to find relationships, I'm like, okay, I can understand it.
Yeah.
But if it's your couple and you're going on a TV show, you're stupid.
Yeah.
You're just dumb. You're trying to blow up your relationship if that's your thing.
I think you're right there. It's like literally, they're at a point where they don't want to end it, but it's kind of is hit a roadblock.
Yeah.
And then they're like, okay, let's see if something's gonna happen on here which is gonna end it, or I can't find anything else right now, so I'll just still stay with them. So either way, I'm winning. But yeah, I don't know. I like the concept of them. I like these reality shows. I think they're a good idea and good entertainment usually as well, because obviously there's a lot of drama and stuff in them.
What happened to Big Brother?
That got boring.
That got very boring, yeah. I think because, again, that one was one where it's like, had a lot of entertainment and kind of reality show elements, and it was very fun to watch, and it always had drama and stuff. But once they start just doing celebrity stuff, then it just goes downhill, because that's what Big Brother did. They just had celebrity Big Brother, and even the normal one, it had the Z-list celebrity stars in it who have already been in reality shows, and it's just like, it's not really Big Brother anymore, it's just like a celebrity show. It just kind of goes downhill.
Yeah. I mean, I think for me, even like The Apprentice and stuff, like, I'll watch it more time. In fact, to be fair, I've given up on The Apprentice because Alan Sugar's been really annoying like these last few years. But
he's old, man. I think he's going a bit senile, you know.
Yeah, but
his Twitter account is really like, very questionable with it right now.
So I can't support that anymore. But I did like that back in the day, but it was still kind of messy. Like, it was, a lot of it had nothing to do with business, like, at the end of the day.
Yeah. Like they're definitely just as messy as the relationship ones, but I feel like the people going on, I can respect the people more that go onto these shows because they're trying to get money out of it, or a business situation, out of it. And it just makes more sense to me to go on these shows. And then they generally come out of it with something as well. Even if they don't win the whole thing, they generally come out of it with some kind of exposure or what.
Like, that happens.
Same with reality shows, other shows like Love Island and stuff. Them, like Molly May, she's doing big right now.
Oh, but I don't respect those people.
Damn.
If you go into a relationship show and come out of it, like, I don't know, what is she doing big? Doing what?
So she's just got, like, she's doing YouTube now. She's got over a million followers. Yeah, they're just influencers, basically. She's doing these Louis V giveaways, which get loads of likes and posts and
stuff. So you respect Katie Hopkins more than you respect the influencer? Katie Hopkins was on The Apprentice.
Okay, but I don't know anything. I don't know who that is.
You don't know who that is?
Oh, wow. I know her name. I just don't know what has she done. I don't.
Bloody hell, man.
I have zero thoughts of her. So
she's a big time racist. Then everything is everything.
She's a horrible
and
woman.
I'm sure she was on The Apprentice before my time.
No, I wasn't that long ago.
Well, then, yeah, I don't know anything about her, so I can't.
Is that how she got big, from The Apprentice?
First of all, yeah.
Okay, I didn't even know. I just literally know from Twitter, from her.
And like, if they do stuff after the fact, then obviously this, my thoughts will change. But on the initial.
Okay, I get that.
Yeah, but if you go on and think, I don't really have much respect for you.
So you're loving the Great British Bake Off ones and that.
Yeah, they're respectable people.
What, KSI and that, them, man? They were on Great British Bake Off, weren't they?
Were they?
They have the one most recent one for KSI was on it.
Well, that sounds like garbage.
All right, we guess we have to withdraw Cam's Love Island application.
Actually, no, we should definitely put Cam on Love Island.
I think we should all apply and just see what happens. So I think we should.
That'd be so boring, man.
I think we should all apply.
Nah. I'd be just in there screw facing.
I would as well. I think I'd get kicked off within a week or so, but it'd be funny.
I'd be gone. Either I'm going on there and I'm not saying anything, or I'm going on there and I'm roasting every single one of them. And then
your
that
shoes,
will keep me on.
Whack.
Like,
yeah.
Like, that will keep me on for just telling them what I think, you know, speaking my mind. But yeah.
Yeah, no, I think, like, Love Island, I was talking to my friend about this, and like, she was like, what would you be like if you were on one of these reality TV shows? Like, would you try it? I'm like, I absolutely would not try it at all. Like, I'd just be there, like, looking at everyone. I'd be like, you man are corny. You girls are.
Do you want to go for a chat?
Like, get out of my face, man.
That's what I'm saying. Like, these people.
I just want to know where your head is at. Like, nah, get out of here, man. Taking a piss.
Yeah, but it depends which one you go on. Like, if you go on, like, X on the Beach or something, that's like just made for drama. And then it's just like, it's not, you're not really on there to find love or anything. You're just on there just to party and then have your ex come in and cause drama and obviously and all that kind of thing.
If I can be on a show where I'm drama adjacent, where I'm like on the outside looking in.
See, that's why Big Brother was good, because the in Big Brother, you could have people who were drama adjacent, because essentially it's just putting a bunch of people in a house and seeing what happens.
Yeah.
Some people cause drama and other people are just looking at it like, yeah.
And the quiet ones always get far because they're just, they didn't cause any issues, so they're not really on TV. It's either the ones who cause a lot of drama go far, or the quiet ones, because until they start getting picked on because they're like, you're just playing a game, that's why you're being quiet. And I was like, no, I'm just quiet.
I think, like, for me, all right, so let's say, what reality TV shows would you guys go on and actually, like, get involved? Because we've spoken about this before. We said we'd go on Take Me Out.
I never said I'd go on Take Me Out.
No, he did. You said you'd come down elevated, you go across, you kiss the one on the farthest one on the cheek, and then you go to the other side, you give the girl a 12. Like,
yeah, this sounds like me. This sounds
like what I would say.
Yeah, doing the hip thrust with the click. Like,
I remember that now.
Yeah, it's coming back to me.
The only reality TV show that I've actually watched more than like a good few episodes of is Terrace House.
What's that?
It's a Japanese reality TV show.
Okay, talk to me.
So it's literally just a house of three girls, three guys. They put them in. They live life.
Okay, so like a Jersey Shore, Geordie Shore sort of thing.
Yeah, but obviously they are encouraged to form relationships.
Do they do like challenges and stuff?
No, they literally just live.
They like go clubbing and just stuff like that.
I mean, they don't go clubbing because I don't know. They like, it's weird. I don't know. They don't really do much. Now that I'm thinking about it, they don't really do much. They're in the house because it's all like young people, like between 18 and like, I feel like 18 and like sometimes 18 to 31, the people in the house are. So they're all like trying to be in the house, and their reasons for going on are like, I'm bored, or like I'm stagnating in my career or whatever, so I want to have a new scenery,
yeah,
and trying to push myself that way. So like you have like musicians go on and whatnot.
Okay.
And like I think there was like a mangaka on one time. Mangaka.
Oh, mad.
Oh, right.
And and like there's a bunch of models and that also go on there. But like, the reason why I liked it is because it felt more real. It didn't feel like it was like trying to play up the drama. Like, if there was drama, it was legit drama.
It does sound a bit boring, yeah. Would you go on that one?
Would I go on it?
Yeah.
If I was to go on anything, I would probably go on that, because it is just chill. They are just living, but yeah, obviously there is some drama there. Because they are six people meeting for the first time, living in a house together, so there's bound to be some drama.
But you didn't wash your dishes.
Because you have someone who's 31 living with someone who's 18.
Yeah,
it's bound to get techie. There's been times where
sounds just like uni.
The youngest is just not pulling his weight. People are pissed. They're like, bro, you need to like just grow, like just grow up. And then one time, this 18-year-old, he was like, he wanted to be, okay, this his statement was, I want to be Spider-Man. His meaning was, I want to be an actor and play Spider-Man. But he wasn't working towards that at all. Like, he wasn't getting acting lessons or anything. Like, there was an older person who was an actress in the house, and he wasn't talking to her, trying to get like any advice or anything on what to do. He was just living and just lazing around the house. And then everyone was like, they had an intervention for him and everything. And so, like, the next episode, he tried to fix up and he cooked a meal for himself. And it was just trash. He did like rice and like some semi-boiled broccoli and like some kind of stew. I can't remember what it was exactly, but it was just like everyone was laughing at him. To his face, obviously. No. They were like, is this what he made? Oh, it's peak. He truly doesn't know how to cook. He truly is a kid. But yeah, I mean, he tried to make steps to better himself, but yeah.
And he got pod.
And there was one guy who went on it, and he was just super wholesome. So it was enjoyable to watch because like everyone liked him.
Mm.
And then like he wasn't trying to make moves to anyone because he had a girlfriend already. But he was just there, and he was like the rock of the house kind of thing. And it was interesting to just watch him build friendships with the other housemates. And,
I don't know, man. I don't think I could watch this one.
I couldn't watch that one.
I mean, it's also in Japanese, so you definitely wouldn't watch it.
Yeah,
no chance.
Not a chance.
But
no,
it's interesting. Like, it does have a fairly large following of.
Was it called Terrace House?
Terrace House. Yeah.
No. Yeah. No.
It's on Netflix. One. That's why I watched it. That's why I saw it. Anyways.
Yeah, definitely a weeaboo show. Can't lie. I think for me, I'd go in the circle because that concept definitely.
Would you catfish or would you just be?
I'd be me because. I just think it would be too awkward, like, if I get far enough to, like, have to reveal myself to then be revealing myself after catfishing.
Yeah.
Like, I would definitely just be me. But
haven't you done that before?
Hmm? What?
I said, but haven't you done that before?
Catfished?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Not catfished, I'm joking. But not provided the whole information about you.
Ooh.
Okay. Let's move on. Continue.
Not just coming for me. Coming for you.
You definitely have.
Have I?
Yeah.
The whole, not giving, where you told certain stories
about things that aren't true. Like,
you man are gassing big time.
What do you want? Do you want receipts?
Bro, we could drop receipts, but
you man are gassing big time. You are making things seem like what they're not.
Like when you like just play sign up a little bit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that obviously that happens. Everyone does that, but that's not what Cam's referring to.
Isn't
I know what Cam's referring to, but it's nowhere near in the realm of catfishing.
I know, no, that's not catfishing, but like.
But just, but you don't go, like, we're talking about catfishing, you don't go.
You said,
you know what I'm saying?
No, because you said the issue would be revealing yourself. So, like, obviously, you told one thing, which wasn't 100% the truth, and then you had to tell the truth at some point.
There's levels to this game. I know this is what you're talking about, but there's levels, and like what you're talking about is like a one, and catfishing is like a million. Like, there's so many.
When you put your picture up as a model white girl, and then you gotta go meet the person you've been the guy you've been flirting with, and then it's the else.
And that's what I'm saying. Like, what are you talking about? It's a totally different.
Yeah,
role.
When you start at a one, you always work your way up. So you were preparing yourself.
Oh my days, this guy.
So basically, you're just getting started.
Nah.
I'm saying you're ready.
Absolutely not. I hate you both. But yeah, nah, I would definitely be me. And I'd just go in there. But I would definitely go in there and just cause carnage. Like, I'd be like, I would just be like accusing everyone of being catfish.
Yeah.
even if they look like the most normal, regular person, like, nah, you're trying to catfish me, aren't you?
Yeah. It's funny. I like that show. I need to watch season 2 still, but it's a good concept.
Wasn't there like another thing that just got released for that?
Yeah, because they're releasing episodes every week or so. So I think the season 2 just dropped, but obviously they're released. There's like the 6 episodes are now dropped or something, but they still like another 4 to go. So got a bit more.
I feel like there's more than 6 now.
There might be more than 6. Yeah, it might be 8 or even more.
I think it's almost done, I think. But yeah, no, I think I'd do that. I wouldn't do like, I don't think I would do any of the explicitly relationship ones.
Mm.
But I think I do, like, I'm not doing, like, no, I'm a celebrity, get me out of here. I'm not doing any of those.
Oh, yeah,
no,
I couldn't do that one.
All them challenges and that, just killer. Like, no way.
Go home day one.
Have you watched The Challenge?
The Challenge?
Yeah.
Nah, what's that?
That's a good one, which is, like, it's basically, it's not, like, quite like I'm a Celebrity where you're, like, eating testicles and shit. But you're, like, basically, you're on a game show, but you have to run challenges. So it might be, like, you have to do a hardcore, like, let's say just swim, for example. Like, you have to, like, 2 lengths of the pool to get something from the other end, bring it back, dump in again, get something back, bring it back. So it's just doing random challenges, a bit like, not like Ninja Warrior, but kind of those kind of level challenges. So you might have to swing across a pool and dive into the pool, climb up a frame, and you just do challenges, and whoever like wins the challenge, they get to pit someone against someone else in the pit, and then the person gets eliminated who loses. So it's kind of, you win like $1 million or something at the end of it. It's just like, yeah, it's just quite a good competition kind of challenge show. So, but it's not quite like I'm a Celeb where you're eating.
Doing a madness.
But it's still like...
It's like a Bake Off or MasterChef in that you're doing challenges with... Like physical challenges as opposed to cooking
basically.
Stuff.
And then they had the reality element as well where people are still getting together and having drama between them and arguments and fights and all this. But then obviously, yeah, then you, the next day, then you go in and you're doing a 10-mile bike hike or something, and then having to run back, and whoever does quickest wins the challenge, sort of thing. So
I would literally do anything. I would go on any reality TV show that just it doesn't have any isn't specifically
designed relationship. Yeah.
I
hear that. Like, I was literally just thinking, like, I would go in Hell's Kitchen.
Yeah,
can't cook, but I'll go.
I'll be there. Like, roast me, Gordon. I swear to God, do it.
No, I'll just be like in the background giggling when he's roasting someone. Like, and then he'd
then he come over to you because you're just there laughing. And I'd still just be laughing in his face, like, come on, bro, chill out.
Because I'm English as well. That's so funny. Like, obviously, like, they're like Americans getting roasted by, like, oh, he's British and stuff.
Yeah.
So he says stuff that they're not used to. Like, so, like, but for me, it'll just be like, it's too much.
It's funny because I swear, Americans don't seem wanker as a swear word, I feel like. Cause I see it in a lot of shows just dropped randomly when they're using British people.
Yeah,
and it just drops like any shows, like, come on, you wanker, like, casually. I was like, yeah, that's a proper swear word, like.
Yeah, no, but that happens all the time. Like, I see, even in, like, say, British shows, I've seen a British show with a Japanese person, and the Japanese person was saying, I can't remember, but, you know, the kusura or whatever, like, them kind of, like, like, they're doing all of that, and I was like, I swear these are swear words in Japanese. Like, but, yeah, I think it's just as long as, like, people...
who are watching don't understand it.
Yeah, don't understand, so they can't complain.
Yeah.
It's fine, yeah.
That's the thing, like, because Gordon Ramsay, like, if he's calling someone a wanker, they might not quite get how rude he's being in America, but then if we're there, you're like...
But yeah, like, it's so funny though, I didn't realize, like, Americans, like, some of our, like, curses or the way that we curse, they don't use them, and like, it's something I only realized the other day, but like, when you tell someone to, like, fuck off, that's not something that Americans say, like, and I didn't realize
don't
that.
They
no
they
don't. Yeah, they literally don't. I remember because you know Grey Worm,
yeah,
the actor for him went on a YouTube channel with these other two dudes, and they were playing Mario Kart, and obviously, like, there's blue shells and whatnot getting thrown at him, and he says, oh, F off, and they're like, what? Say that again. And so he, like, says it multiple times in the episode because they've never heard, like, someone say that specific, like, phrase before.
Yeah.
And they're like, this is weird.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Like, they definitely don't they don't use that phrase. Like, obviously they say F you, like, da, 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 but F off is not something that they say, like, and obviously we obviously do the whole, you're taking a piss, like, da, 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 and again, they don't say, like, these kind of things.
Taking the what?
yeah, and they don't use the C word, like, anywhere near what we do in, like, Australians and that.
Australians are even worse than us. They're way worse than us.
Too much. Every other sentence.
But yeah, no, it's quite funny. Like, sometimes you'll see, like, American people on Twitter, like, just talking about British words that they picked up from, like, watching, you know, like, Top Boy,
or, yeah,
like, whatever. And they're just loving it. Like, I saw someone just gassing over the word wasteman. It's like, yeah, no, I started calling my boyfriend a wasteman. It's so funny. You know, jokes. But yeah, like, it's just always so interesting because obviously I feel like even if we don't use, like, Americanisms, we're familiar with them just because,
like, the amount of American stuff that we watch.
Exactly. Like, and they just don't have the same experience. Which is it's quite funny, but yeah, man, it is what it is.
The thing is, like, you see, like, American people, they still think British slang is like the hello, hello, mate, how are you doing? Like that. And it's like, nah, what are you talking about? And then you see some American people now who've watched Top Boy and they start doing the proper. Like,
the roadman.
Yeah, roadman talking, like, oh, you're closer now at least, but it's not quite the hello, old boy. Yeah, that kind of old chat.
That's literally their go-to, is like the tea and crumpets, like,
and the British and water. I've seen bare things
water,
like that.
Water.
We've just cut out the tea. We don't cut out the teas in our words.
Like, yeah, obviously I have an American friend. And she used to always try and, like, mock me. Like, she's like, oh, like, you say water. I'm like, no, I don't emphasize the tea that you do. Because she used to say, like, she used to be like, water. Like, I'm having a glass of water.
Yeah.
Like, she would, like, in her accent, but she would fully, like, emphasize it. And I'd just say water.
Yeah.
But, and then she'll just take it, that, and be like, oh, no, you water. Say water,
the tea.
Water,
like,
water.
You say the tea.
But because
it's not print, water, print. Yeah. Like that. I just say water, and she's like, water. And then she just takes that and just goes, what?
Bro, I remember when we went to America, they literally couldn't understand what we were saying. And we're speaking the same language. And it was just like, because I remember we went to, I think we went to KFC, and my sister was like, oh, do you have a, do you have butter? What? Butter.
Butter.
What?
Butter.
Oh, butter.
Yeah. Butter.
Butter. And he's like, oh my God, really? Like, do you have a knife? What? The knife, is we need a knife to spread it. Do you mean you, tissues? Like, what? And no, a knife to spread it. Oh, a knife. Oh, yeah, sure. Like, what are you talking about? We're speaking the same language.
I'm actually finished because I can butter. Imagine that. I can imagine. Butter.
It literally is. Oh my God. Are you crazy? Like, we're literally speaking the same. I said literally, butter. You said butter.
That's actually the reverse of them mocking us for saying water. Like, they're not pronouncing the word properly. Like, no. It's butter. Butter, whatever.
Butter.
Like, butter.
Butter.
So you have to say the word the same way. So if you want butter, not butter, or nah, butter.
If I went to America, because I haven't been yet, I was meant to go last year, but COVID obviously ruined. But if I went to America, I feel like I would eventually just start like mocking them.
Yeah.
Like, I just feel like I would go to KFC, whatever, and be like, oh yeah, no, can I have some butter?
Okay, butter. Butter.
Can I have butter?
And the funny thing is, they'll understand you straight away as well. They'll be like, yeah, here you go.
I'd be giggling inside. I'd be dying inside. But yeah, that's the vibe that I'm on, man. That's how I feel. But man, we're like 50 minutes in and we ain't really like touched on any of the topics yet. We flipped this whole thing and said,
yeah.
But yeah, now let's get into one of the topics then. I guess briefly we can discuss these things. Did you guys see that in Liverpool that they had a test party, like a club night? Like,
yeah, I saw that.
No social distancing, no nothing. They had DJs no masks. Like the place, I saw like a video, and it was just like, it was literally like a rave. People was standing,
testing whether they catch COVID or not.
I think testing can go ahead, sort of thing. Yeah,
yeah. So like everyone that attended had to take COVID tests and get like a negative COVID test to go. But I think it was just like the logistics of like obviously getting people in, like, and all of these things. But yeah, no, it was Ram. The music was terrible, but it was just, like Ram.
Like, it looked like a festival or something from the picture. I don't get why they did it in Liverpool. Like, what, of all places? Why not? Why Liverpool though? Who's in Liverpool?
It's a big city, loads of people.
Is it? Is anyone there really?
Are you hating on Liverpool? What have the Scouts ever done to you?
They're just, yeah, it's not London, is it?
I mean, it's not London, but London would have been mad.
London would have been crazy, but that's what I'm saying, bro. Get it cracking in London, man. Come on, Boris.
Maybe Liverpool's got less COVID. Maybe that's why. Who knows?
Maybe, yeah, that's true. But yeah, it looked like it was a good time, and obviously it means that things are going back to normal, or they're at least trying to put things back to normal. That's a good sign, sort of.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I mean, they're saying that this can go ahead from June, which is only, well, the end of June.
Next month.
So to next month. But yeah, pretty much like a month and a bit. And we're apparently going to be back in the game. Obviously, yeah, we got tickets.
Yeah.
We got tickets.
We're going to be outside.
So we're going to be outside as soon as. So we'll see if it goes ahead. It's going to be so mad. Like, it's going to be like, I feel like it's going to be like very, what's the word? Lethargic? Is that the word?
That means like tired.
Then that's definitely not the word.
Lethargic is like,
like relieved, no?
Yeah. Like a
sort of, I thought lethargic is like, just lazy sort of meaning.
I feel like it possibly.
Well, that's cathartic. I don't know.
Cathartic maybe what you're saying. Actually, yeah.
Well, either way, I'm thinking like it's gonna be a moment, isn't it? One of the ones where you're just like, oh man, this feels good.
So you need to hear like the old school, like, you know what, like 2015 maybe, the kind of music where it's like, what was it? What's the band called again? They are like Lumen or something. They had like, there's all these, like, you know, when they're playing like the pop music kind of thing.
The pop music?
Like, yeah, like the, this is when they were all making the big pop tunes, like, I can't remember any of them, like Titanium, them kind of songs.
Oh, David
Guetta
and that.
Yeah, them kind of songs where they, like, you get the freeze everybody. Like them ones where you get gassed and you can all just, you're just living life.
I can't lie, I can think of nothing that I would least like.
They just need to just take it back to 2018. Just, I want to hear some freaking some Bodak Yellow and these things.
Say a little bit. Yeah.
Oh, I need to. Oh my god! I remember we went out once, and that song came on. My sister was just gassing up. Was you there? Gassing up one girl in a relationship, and the man looked pissed. That's the end of the relationship. Then,
the girl was just rapping it hard. You can fuck me if you wanted to. Nah, man, I need to go, and listen to some like underground music, man. Obviously, that's not gonna happen for a good while. But I need it, inject it, yeah man, like we were saying the other day, the dubstep in Ghana, man, that's what I need.
I need that Koch.
Wine and Koch.
All right, my guy.
work. Yeah, nah, literally, like if we're talking like time frames, like take me back to like let's get that 2016 music running, man.
Yeah,
let's get that 2015, 2016 vibe.
Versace. Yeah. That's before, isn't it? 2016 was like Bad and Bougie in them days, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's more the point. Uzi like, that was like XO Tour Life in that.
Good times, man. Good times, man. Yeah. Hey! Uzi shoulder roll.
Yeah, man, them times. Let's go.
Yeah, man, I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully it will go ahead all right and stuff, man. I'm looking forward to properly getting back out. Obviously, me being out yesterday, you just want to be inside and just be able to dance and stuff. It's just, I hate being out, having to sit down. Like, I'm not in school. Don't tell me to keep telling me to sit down. Like, I'm a big man, you know.
Yeah, nah. 100%. Just want to be able to, like, yeah. I just want to hear loud music again. The worst part is, yeah, there's nothing really stopping us from playing loud music, but... No one's doing it.
Yeah, I don't get why. It's because they want to stop people dancing, isn't it? And they want people to get gassed.
Yeah, but I want to hear loud music again. And yeah, I want to be able to do a little two-step.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And there's just bare songs that have come out and actually to hear in clubs and stuff like over this last 2 years.
Yeah, so many. Like, Backrow G's entire career. Nah, not really. Like, I need to hear a Backrow G club in the party. I want to see what that does. I feel like it's just going to be violence.
There's definitely going to be like, some fights. You know what I'm saying? Fights are going to get...
It doesn't have to be fights. It could just be mosh pits.
Yeah. But in the club, you don't really mosh... I guess, yeah, not...
I mean, like, fabric. You know what I'm talking... Like, yeah, so like a fabric would mosh pit, but...
It'll be there once where you do the little jump into the side and like you get everyone do it like...
But that's what I'm saying, yeah. So it doesn't need to be like too much. And that's the thing. You don't want to go like... I don't want to go out with kids. I'm done with the like... My life, partying with kids, that's over. I do not want to go to a rave and see 18-year-olds. I'm sorry, I'm tapped out.
Bruv, the funny thing is what I'm saying, like, I think me and my sister talking about this, we're like, right now, we've been in lockdown for 2 years. Oh. So if you're out in June and anyone's 18, they're 16 really, because they've been in lockdown for the past 2 years. They haven't got their stripes yet, so they ain't really 18. They ain't got that experience yet, I'm saying. So really, they're 16 still, and it's just like... If you're in a club and there's 80 years, you're like, nah, you're way too young. You didn't know it's like outside. You ain't been outside.
I'm just talking over 21 raves, over 25 if I can. Like over 21, definitely. Over 25 if I can. Cam's just screwing because he can't.
I'm not screwing.
Can't make it.
Over 21's for Cam and then a couple over 25 ones on the side.
I want to, let's get over 25 raves and let's just play 90s music, man.
Nah.
I want to be in there like... Dance it to Aaliyah, man. I want you to rock the boat. Rock the boat.
Nah, man. I ain't here for that. It's because you see me sit down and just like hate my life.
Don't want to catch a wine to like
trying to go to a house rave still.
You mad, man.
4-4 all night. Let's hear it.
Unts, yeah?
Yeah, man. Just get it. Some deep house.
To be fair, if it was like 2012, 2013, that times, like Disclosure, and like Gorgon City and Julio Bashmore, like them times, come with it. Come with it, my selector. Yeah,
there's
man.
So much like old periods of music that I'm trying to hear, man.
Yeah, definitely. Like
that I missed out on because I was too young. Jesus.
Like, and that's what I kind of want to do. Like, once we're free, that's what I kind of want to do. I want to go to a dubstep rave. I want to go to a rave where I can hear some funky house. Like, I want to hear like, and with that, with funky, I want to hear like the ones that I heard when I was like young.
Party hard.
Yeah, like Party Hard, Migraine Skank, like
all them ones.
I want to hear them ones, but I also want to hear the ones that older lot were raving to at the time, because the older lot got mad that the kids got into. I remember hearing like this conversation. Like I had a conversation with someone about funky house. He was like, "How old is he? If I'm 26, he's probably like 32, 33." So he was like outside when funky house was like big and like blowing up, and he was saying he once like our generation kind of started to get hold of it, or even the not even our generation, the generation above us started to get hold of it.
Yeah,
he was like, that was the beginning of the end, because that's when you got all like the skank songs and all like those.
Yeah,
songs.
Yeah.
But he was like, nah, before that it was so good because you had like actual like songs, like people, like you had people singing, like it was so smooth. It was just grown people music, and then like the MCs got hold of it and started doing all the skanks. I want the head, shoulders, knees and toes, like, all of that. Which
still bust a mic, yeah. Still bust a mic with a skank.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, we obviously love that, but I want to hear like the grown people stuff as well. See what that was about.
Yeah.
Since I'm grown now, you know.
Nah, man, give me the tribal skank. Give me the migraines. Give me all the skanks. I'm ready for it. I'm ready to bust all the skanks.
The way I'd love to go to just a old school garage rave. Like just vibes, just vibes, pure vibes,
vibes, man. Vibes, vibes, vibes. But it needs to be a good old school garage rave though, because I don't want to go there and hear "I'll Bring You Flowers" for like, like on rotation, like, and "Sweet Like Chocolate Boy." Like, I don't want to hear like them ones. I want to hear, give me some like actual like bumpy stuff, like mix it up, man. Give me that Steve Gurley, give me that MJ Cole, like, yeah, man. Switch out. Can't be all the bait ones all the time.
Yeah,
Bez, you'll be there, mate. Bez, you'll be there.
I'll be there, but I ain't gonna want it. I'm always there, but I'm not on it. But I'll be there.
But yeah, nah. Definitely, obviously, yeah, a lot of like popular music that I want to hear. Yeah, the NSG and Back Road G song that came out the other day. I want to hear that in the club. I want to see what that's like.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I want to hear some drill in the rave. I don't think I've heard like drill was around, but it wasn't where.
It wasn't.
Obviously, you had like Russ, Gunleen, and Keisha Becky. That kind of they got like a decent kind of rotation, or whatever. And I think like there was a couple others, like obviously Big
Pop Smoke,
Big
couple Shack Pop Smoke well, ones,
Pop Smoke ones, like wherever. But I feel like now you could go to the club, and
it could be a drill night. It could literally be, exactly, you could go to a drill night.
I definitely would not be choosing to
go to. I wouldn't want to go to a drill night either, no way. That would be violent as shit, man. Oh my, could you imagine?
Just walk in there.
Lock off, straight away.
Yeah. Don't want to stereotype and all that, but yeah, nah, that does not sound like a good idea by any stretch of the imagination. But yeah, nah, there's definitely like been some good like drill tunes that I would want to hear in the dance, man.
Yeah.
See what that's about. Or even drill beats. Play the instrumentals. Do it. Do it. I'm there for it.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Come on to that still.
Yeah. Come on. Like, even that Drake and Heady One tune came out in the pandemic, didn't it?
Yeah. So that was last year. That was like last year summer.
Yeah, I want to hear Drake off beat. It wasn't even off beat. People were gassing so much. It wound me up. But yeah, I want to hear that.
Jay's got loads of songs now that he's brought out. His new songs are good as well. I like his new stuff. What's Next and that. They're all quite good. So I would like to hear them in a rave. And DJ Khaled brought out his new album. Yeah, he's got a couple bangers on there. It's the best stuff, man. Please, let us out. I don't know if you saw that as well on the festival thing or the night out. There was a lot of people complaining about it, saying, oh, they're doing unsolicited partying. They're doing this. And you know, a lot of people were reporting it. So a lot of people on Twitter are saying like, look at our country. Our country is full of snitches and just rats. Like, what the hell's wrong with them? It's like, you see how funny rats. You just go and report it, because the police tweeted like, we're getting a lot of reports about what's happening in Liverpool with the club night. This is actually a test club. We've allowed it to happen. We know it's happening. We're letting it happen. And yeah, they're just like, people, man, just let people have fun.
Snitches and rats.
Yeah. Morgan Freeman. Yes. <Jeez.
laughs> Oh man.
That again, 21 Savage's album, like, pandemic times.
Yeah, was it for real? It was, yeah.
Jesus, this was like, that was like ages ago.
It was like last, what, September or something?
Yeah.
October maybe.
Something like that. Yeah, 21.
Snitches and rats. Oh, God. The only difference between a snitch and a rat. Like, Morgan Freeman's a legend, man.
Yeah, no, he did so well on that album, I can't lie. He made that album epic.
And I'll say it. He's got a song with Justin Bieber, 21 Savage, Justin Bieber on DJ Khaled's album. Right. It's actually sick.
Mad.
Not a fan of Justin Bieber, but that song was sick.
Yeah, man. Like, yeah, nah, they need to free us. Like, too much has happened, and I need to, yeah. Like, I'm sure there's even, like, things, people and things that I'm remembering. Like, I'm thinking, like, was, like, Roddy Ricch and Lil Baby and them, man, were they around, like, before the
Roddy Ricch was. Roddy Ricch was before, because that was when he, because he had the song with Nipsey Hussle that blew him up.
Oh, right, in the middle. Yeah.
Well, he was around before. Lil Baby kind of had a few, but I've never really.
Trajectory kind of just kept going, innit?
I think more the Baby, though. I feel like he's only had a couple before the pandemic, like maybe one or two. Meg the Stallion, like, she had a few before, but I feel like she's, during the pandemic, she's really
gone clear.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I'm just trying to see, like, what happens, man. I'm definitely looking forward to being outside and being active again.
Yeah.
I just hope, yeah, these club promoters and DJs, man, don't fumble. Please.
Look,
this is a time to do a lot.
Like, you know what I'm saying, have a night out every single day of the week, because people are going to be ready to jump it all the time. I'm definitely going to have to get some time off work after that June 21st just to be outside.
Yeah, no, I hear it. Like, I'm on that vibe as well, like, literally. Because, yeah, like I say, I want to hear everything.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm so, genres, styles, everything.
Like, I'm saying, I'm probably not going to enjoy a lot of them, but I'll be there. I'm still going to be there.
Just be there for it.
I'm there. I want to go on holiday as well, bro. I want to go on holiday. I've already spoken about
you
it before.
You can go
as well.
On international travel from the 17th, apparently.
Is that for, like, leisure travels?
Apparently so.
Oh, mad, okay.
This is what I'm hearing.
17th of June.
May,
yeah. But I think it's not going to be easy, I don't think.
Yeah.
But I think it's going to be allowed.
But I thought that was like for business and stuff, but I guess business is allowed now, isn't it? Mm. Okay. I'll start looking at flights.
Okay.
But then, yeah, speaking of Boris, though, did you see what he was saying the other day about...
Yeah, he was again, but he pretty much said that at the beginning of the pandemic.
He did.
He said, like, he wants 60% of the country to catch COVID.
Yeah. Well, herd immunity will do us all good. Well, we'll be fine. I was shaking hands in the hospital the other day.
Like, yeah, exactly what he was saying. So, like, it's not surprising, but I'm like, yeah, people should be outraged.
Yeah.
Like, he's an outrageous guy. what can I say? He's an outrageous guy.
He needs a trim.
He definitely needs a trim. His like headpiece is just outrageous.
Yeah, man. I was surprised to see him saying it, because it's like, I don't know if it's taken out of context or whatever, but obviously just to actually say that, like, rather than just saying like, oh yeah, we kind of can't have another lockdown. Yeah, he said let the body sit there.
Maybe that's what it is. Like, maybe he was
he's listening to that on the way over.
Is that what he said?
That's the words he said.
Literally said that. He said let the body sit the floor. It's like, we'll let bodies drop or something. We can't have another lockdown. We'll let the bodies drop.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. And then the next week he was like, done. I never went back. Yeah, it's just his music selection for the week.
So Michael Jackson coming out next time. What about us?
Yeah.
What about us?
But yeah, nah, Boris is obviously he's a mad guy, and he's
my
getting
prime minister.
No, prime minister. My prime minister.
Damn, you're Tory, yeah?
Najee.
Oh, man.
Green party all day.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Absolutely. We don't deal with no Labour Party around here. But yeah, nah, politics has obviously been a lot. Like, everything's just been a lot recently.
It's been a lot of everything, and it's just the social media gets a bit draining. I just can't bother with it sometimes.
Mm.
Sometimes it's funny and just, but yeah, sometimes it's just like, I can't bother with it because stuff you see, it's just.
Yeah, sometimes I open it up and I'll be like, okay, no. Like,
today is not the day.
Today is not the day to be on here. Like, nah, we're good. But did you lot see, I mean, obviously, I'm sure you saw bits. But we're a bit late to this conversation, but the Super League.
Oh, yeah.
That came.
Came and went.
Caused like carnage.
Came football like a tornado.
Football is dead. Oh my God. Football is over. And then 2 days later,
gone. It's not even gone because I think Real Madrid and Barcelona are still trying to do it.
With or who? But by, on their ones.
Don't know who's that getting involved.
Every week.
I don't know who's getting involved with it, but they're still talking about it's happening. It has to happen for football's sake. It has to happen. That's what they're saying. So I don't know what they're going to do, but.
All right. They should sign up Nottingham Forest.
They've won a Champions League or two Champions Leagues.
That's
even,
what I'm saying.
So.
This is what I'm saying. Nottingham Forest.
What's the issue with the Super League?
Yeah, what's the issue with it, Biz?
Well, so people are saying that it's just, it ruins football because obviously it takes away the competition part, because if you have a league where there's no promotion, no relegation, it's just all the big teams who have money playing against each other. And it's like, there's no way for any other teams to get into it. So it just takes away, it takes away from what the game is, because like,
so it would just be the best teams of now, and then that would just be.
Yeah,
they're not even the best teams.
They're not the best teams of now. They're the best teams of like 10 years ago.
They're the biggest teams of now, in terms of history and fan base.
But they're not, because Spurs haven't got history. Spurs ain't got money.
They've got money. They've got money.
They got a bit of money. They ain't.
They've got more money than who's about West Ham.
Who's the ones that would have been going from England?
Arsenal, Chelsea, Man City, United, Liverpool, Spurs. Them six. So they're like the big six in England.
Yeah.
So yeah. So they, and they're there because they have big fan bases. They've got money.
Yeah.
And apart from Spurs, have
have history.
History.
Even City ain't got much history either. But they got recent. Yeah. They got recent. But it's like it's just because it picks them. Because they've obviously got the biggest fan bases and can make the most money, make the most revenue, then picks them and puts them into a league with like, so it was Barcelona, Real Madrid, AC Milan, Inter Milan. Who else?
Bayern?
No, Bayern said no.
Bayern said no.
PSG said no. It was Atletico Madrid, I think, as well.
Atletico.
Juventus.
Yeah,
and I think it was it was those 12. And they were trying to get a couple other teams to join them, so it would have been a bit more, but they essentially wanted a league between them and obviously with the Champions League, you can have like Leicester, who won the league a couple of years ago, and they got in the Champions League. But with this league, there's no way in for any other team. So it just took away the whole, what's the point in football when you can't really.
But so alongside that, the other league would still be going on?
Yeah,
but they were threatening to kick them out.
They were threatening the Premier League was like, if you lot join this, you're getting kicked out.
Yeah.
Oh wait, so it would be going. So they would still be playing in the Premier League, like alongside.
That's what they planned
to
do.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
But the Premier League were saying nah.
Nah, you get kicked out.
But it would have been midweek games, isn't it?
I think would have been instead of Champions League sort of thing.
Yeah, so. Instead of Champions League. Yeah.
Oh, I see.
They were saying, yeah, we're gonna.
So it would have been like a year long like thing.
It is a year long thing.
Yeah.
But like the Champions League is a year long thing as well.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was like a. I don't know.
No, you do. Group, you have the group, stages, have the group stages. Then you go to the
knockout stages after a few months.
And yeah, so the group
Champions League actually finishes last. Like it's the last game of the season, Champions League
final. Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, it would have replaced the Champions League as a midweek thing. So yeah, they were trying to piece out of UEFA, but like in terms of the home leagues, they were still trying to do that. But the Premier League were like, nah,
it's not happening. Yeah, I see. But the thing is, the reason that the Premier League and all that will have an issue with it is because they're going to lose money. And Sky Sports will lose money, BT will lose money. That's why they were all having issues with it. They didn't care about the fans. They didn't care about us.
Nah, definitely not.
They just wanted to not lose money. And then,
but wouldn't the fans just get more consistent, good football?
They would potentially. They would. But that's why Sky, like BT, obviously they have Champions League. So whoever gets this new league, I don't know who it would be, but they would take it away from BT.
Because it's like, and because it's American, or because it's backed by JP Morgan, which is an American firm, people were saying that this new league It wouldn't be on BT or it wouldn't be on Sky. It would just be internationally on Amazon, or it'd be internationally on, like, basically something like that. It wouldn't be BT Sports or Sky. Mm. It would be something bigger than that. It would be like an American firm. What other American, like, streaming services are there?
Hulu or like HBO.
Nah, but ones that we can access.
Yeah. HBO we can access, I think.
Can we?
I think so. Max,
yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, right. Okay. But yeah, it would be like one of the big American streaming services rather than your niche BT Sport or your niche like Sky Sports. That's what people were speculating. Mm. Which would, because obviously they're trying to, the whole thing was they're trying to like exploit the international market, which is why they chose the clubs that they did, because they've got the biggest international fan bases. So they're trying to, it wouldn't be on Sky Sports or BT Sports because that's local. They want it to be on something that's international and able to be accessed everywhere. I think it probably would have been Amazon, honestly. Probably would have been Amazon Prime.
Yeah.
I mean, conceptually,
I have no qualms with it.
The teams that would be playing and whatnot, it should just be more consistently good football throughout the year. Like, because obviously,
you say that, but Arsenal are terrible.
I say my issue of it is that we would get fucked every week.
That may give you a lot more motivation to be better.
The thing is, though, for us, it's like the owners we have, we would have got more money from this league because I think they were going to give each team joining the league £3 billion. Each team joining the league, and then 300 million a year or something as they join. So obviously we'd get a lot more revenue in and we can sign players, but our owners take all the money from our club and don't give us any money. So we would have no money to spend and be in this league with Barcelona, Real Madrid, United, City, all these big teams in which we'd be the Sheffield United of that league. Just losing every week. I mean,
someone has to be.
But not Arsenal, please. So if any team, I couldn't.
He's getting pumped 10-0.
Bro, I couldn't deal with it. I'd have to quit. I'd have to quit football.
It's so funny to me because I have a few friends who are Arsenal fans, and I used to be in a group chat with them, like, and I left the group chat 2 years ago or something like that. And I just recently joined the group chat back. And the messages my friend used to send used to always be, "Oh, Arsenal. I come back. First message I see from this guy, "Oh." I'm like, it's still like that. And he was, from back then, he was saying, "I just stopped watching football." And he's still now watching them just.
We're down bad. I don't know why I still watch it. I literally, the other day I was watching us, I'm like, why do I watch this? I was going to tweet, I'm like, why do I put myself through this? I don't need to do this.
That's a good question.
I don't need to do this. I have no I haven't seen us play good for so long. I don't know why I put myself through this pain, but I still do.
You're in an entanglement with Arsenal.
That's it. That's what it is. That's what it is. I'm in entanglement with Arsenal. Yeah, literally. Oh, man. But yeah, the Super League, I don't know. It's, for me, it was the whole competition part. I just think you should have. I think it's good that Champions League is there, that it gives everyone the opportunity to get into it. Like West Ham this season could be in the Champions League next season. And it's like, it's a good opportunity for the littler teams to have a chance at least to get in. Obviously, with the big teams, how they have more money, they can buy better players and all that. So there's already the disadvantage for them. Mm. But then now you're just like saying, scrap that. You just aren't getting it at all, which is a bit harsh. And that was my thought. That was my thing with it. The whole putting on Amazon, I think that's a good idea. I think it should be on Amazon because BT is annoying and their commentators are shit.
But, but on Amazon, you might get American commentators.
True. And they'll call it soccer.
Like, what a wonderful soccer game we're witnessing here tonight, folks.
They could not. They'd have to start calling it football. They'd have to adopt it.
Amazon have had a few Premier League games and they've got, actually, they had decent commentators, I feel like. Were they? Actually, they had like Robbie Savage in that. Nah, they were pretty dead as well, to be fair.
Nah, no Clive Tisdale, no?
Nah, Clive Tisdale's out of the game. I think he's like Match of the Day now and that, but...
Mad.
Yeah, man. The Super League was a interesting time on Twitter, though. That was one thing.
It was a wild 2 days. Even as someone who doesn't really, like, care about football like that, it was definitely a wild 2 days.
Did teams just start backing out, or what happened?
They backed out.
Because the fans...
Like Gary Backlash. Neville. It was the fans and Gary Neville.
Gary Neville was leading the line, leading the front charge. Him and Jamie Carragher leading the line.
Yeah, they were like, "Nah, this is horrible. You don't care about the fans."
Bullshit. We're gonna lose our wage packet.
Yeah, that's exactly how it is. Like Gary Neville, man, like Gary Neville, who'd been pumping Salford through the non-league.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, cares about competition now.
Exactly. Man. Salvador, like what, League Two now or something? League, and then Paul Scholes and their man have funded their team to get up there. And
they literally did, I think they had like, from what I hear, they've had like 3 promotions in 5 years or something like that.
Something like that. They're just flying through the league.
Flying through because they're just pumping money. Apparently, their striker or whatever his wage is like 3 times that of the next most paid person.
Oh my god.
Like they're just pumping like the team through.
Yeah.
It's wild. I mean, to be fair, his wage probably isn't that much compared to like, obviously Premier League.
Yeah. It's probably still like 3 times the other players, probably still like £500 or something or like £1,000. But it's that still like, compared to everyone else, it's a lot.
Yeah. Compared to like who he's playing against.
Yeah. Because they're all probably semi pro footballers who don't even play football regularly, but still.
Yeah. And they're just juicing that club. Juicing it.
Do you ever think, I was thinking about this a while back, but do you ever think like, I guess they kind of are, but games would be on the level of like football in terms of things people do. Because like back in the day when we were younger and whatnot, we just play football.
Mm-hmm.
Just go outside, play football, whatever.
Yeah.
Do you ever think it'll be a situation where online games would take over?
Online games have taken over. What do you mean?
I know, I was thinking about it. But I mean like... I mean, specifically stuff where, I don't know, it's hard to...
I don't think they'll ever get as paid as much, but...
I mean, like, more like on the recreational hobby side. Yeah, the hobby side of the situation.
But it is. Like, look at our nephew. I feel like he's better at Rocket League than he is at football.
It's true.
Kids don't go out anymore, really.
I don't think, when I was 16, any adult in my life, I would have, like, twang at football because I was playing football like all the time and obviously they weren't. But for me, at 26, any child that I can think of, like a boy child or whatever, like all of them, I would put them all on their ass and I play football in 10 years because they ain't built the same. They ain't built like us. We built different.
They play like their hour at PE and that's about
and
it
that's
probably.
It, and that's it, yeah.
And that's like what, 1 hour, 2 hours a week. Whereas we'd be playing like when you're younger, you play out. The kids don't play out nowadays.
I forget. I'm literally not up to. I don't clock what children are doing.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, obviously, I feel like we were more or less the last generation. We got the balance, innit? We were there when online gaming was coming through, but we were still like at first we were young, so then we were outside, and then online gaming was coming through. And then as we kind of grew up into online gaming, that's when we stopped going out. But
even like phones, tablets, YouTube, all this kind of stuff, we was kind of growing up into it rather than we were in it. So I don't know.
Yeah. So I feel like for the most part, video games have taken over sports.
Yeah.
Like, and I think that's partly what the Super League thing was about as well. They wanted to
make it more like video games.
Yeah. For they wanted to try and engage kids again because it seems like. Again.
How would it be more like video games? In what way?
Well, I don't know if this was actually what he was planning, but Florentino Perez was saying that he wanted to make it more like video games, like make games shorter, make them kind of just so they had more fast paced and more like FIFA, basically. That's what he's trying to do because that's what kids are more interested in. They don't care about
the full 90
minutes. Full 90 minutes. So they just want it to be a quick, like hour maybe, bam, 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 done. But that would be
bad, man. You shouldn't cater to these kids.
But you gotta get the next generation of fans, isn't it? Somehow, like music has literally done that. Like we were just talking, this was before we started recording. We were talking about song lengths, right?
Yeah.
Mm.
And Bez was saying he doesn't like a song to be longer than 2 minutes. Like music was not like that. Like if you tried to release,
I could do a 4 minute song. It's 6 minutes. I can't do.
But like 2 minutes, like. If you see a song nowadays that's 2 minutes long, that's normal, right?
Yeah.
10, 15 years ago, like a 2 minute song, no one was releasing 2 minute songs.
Yeah.
Like that wasn't a thing. It would be like 3.5 minimum, like 3.5, like 4 would be like the standard or whatever. Yeah. Like, but yeah, like if you go back and look at like Michael Jackson's catalog and Prince's catalog or whatever, try and find a 2 minute song. Like you're not going to like, but
quick little interlude.
but because of, yeah, maybe an interlude, but that's not a song, like, but because attention spans on the whole have just shrunk because we have access to so many different things now.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta have, yeah, songs of, song lengths have decreased. I guess we can decrease games. Why
That'd
not?
That'd be so weird, dude.
What, an hour football match?
Yeah, like just anything less than 90 minutes. It would be right. So weird.
It would be strange.
Half an hour halves. 45 minutes is a long time.
It is, but it works. It feels like it works.
It works. I feel like when you're watching a game, it doesn't feel that long.
It does feel that long.
It doesn't.
It does. I've watched football games. It feels like it doesn't feel too long, but it feels like 45 minutes.
It depends on which games. If you're watching like Sheffield United versus Fulham, then yeah, it's going to feel like a long time. But when you're watching games that actually things are happening, you're like, where'd that first half go? Or when you're losing and you're waiting for your team to come back or something.
I feel like a lot of times the first half is so unnecessary as well. Like, I'm not going to lie to you. Like, let's get to, it's kind of how I feel about basketball sometimes as well when I watch a basketball game. Like, if it's close and it just stays close the entire way, like, the game gets exciting.
In the last quarter, the last four, five minutes or something.
Yeah, yeah. That's when it gets hype. Because that's when, you know, the stakes are high. And I think the first half generally is usually like that as well. Especially when it's like a nil-nil, like a scoreless first half.
Yeah.
Like, I'm like, okay, cool. There were some exciting moments or whatever, but did any of this matter? Not really.
Yeah.
But the thing is, I feel like if you cut out the first half, the second half still loses all this excitement.
It wouldn't be as exciting.
Then go ham. Like, if you've only got half an hour to score a goal, like, say, for example, a football game, say they cut football matches from 90 minutes to half an hour,
mm-hmm.
right? And obviously the players are aware that now they don't have to run for 90 minutes. They're only running for half an hour. Yeah. And they only have to do this for 30 minutes. But they've also got to win the game. They've got to score. Do you know how ham that would, how hard they would play, like, for that 30 minutes? They would go ham. It would be mad.
True, but I think the overall entertainment of it, the entertainment level, I feel like it would drop for the viewers.
No, but do you know, all right, so imagine the way I'm seeing it, right, is, you know, them ones where the game is on the line and the keeper comes up for the final corner, whatever. I feel like that would just be the whole game. If you cut the game to like half an hour, that would pretty much be the whole game.
But I don't think it would. It wouldn't be to that level because obviously they still have bags of stamina and stuff, which they're not going to be playing all the way. They're going to still be playing a bit slowly and trying to build up the playing, but it's going to be very attacking.
Yeah.
Each side and counter-attacking. But you get that in like games anyway. Obviously not the first kind of, you get that sometimes in the first 45 where a team might come out and decide to just go hard.
Mm.
And then 30, 45 minutes, you'll go out, you'll attack, and then counter-attack in kind of end-to-end, but they're normally bigger games anyway.
And I feel like the length of a football match gives, like, because towards the end of it, the tension starts to build. Like, if it's a close game, the tension starts to build towards the end of it. If it's a 30-minute game and the tension's supposed to be there instantly, it doesn't, like, you can't reach the level of tension that you're going to have in a 90-minute game in 30 minutes.
You can.
You can't.
You can.
You can't do
it. It'll come in maybe the last couple single, minutes still anyway.
Not every single game.
I mean, like, it wouldn't be every single game, but I'm saying there's a more chance. Like, for example, if you think about it with like movies and stuff, when you're watching a movie,
mm-hmm.
a movie can start off being incredibly tense.
Yeah.
And I feel like this is the same thing.
But then it'll always have the middle period or something where it just dies down.
But that's because of the length of a movie. Like, if you can
but
do...
TV shows never have a full 30 minutes of just craziness, I don't feel like.
They do.
There are.
I can't think of any.
There definitely are some episodes that are just mad.
It's like, they'll start, like, wow, and then they kind of have a calm period and end, wow.
All right, no, actually, in fact, for example, look at John Wick, right? Have you seen, like, John Wick 3? Especially?
Yeah, well, that's just literally just gunfights.
The whole way through.
Yeah.
It's mad, even still
they have the bits where he's just kind of just running through holding his shoulder and then just kind of chilling. And
I'm saying obviously the game's not going to be like shooting from distance the entire game or whatever. Like, there'd be different stages of play and whatnot, but I just feel like it would be more instantly and continually intense than it is currently.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying that
it wouldn't be long enough though.
I feel like investment would drop as also, like, people's investment in the game.
I feel like they could lose interest because
it's like so quick. Huh?
But all right, so for example, I was at my friend's house the other day, and he was watching the boxing, and the entire card, I wasn't really paying that much attention, but every fight is that like on the card, I think all of them ended within the first two rounds.
But if I paid for a box office and that's happened, I'd be pissed. because I paid for the event and I've seen every round end within 2 minutes.
But why?
Because you set yourself up for a two hour, you saw
five knockouts in a row.
But you set yourself up for a 4 hour night sort of thing. You're ready for this, and then it's ended in 2 hours, and you're just like, well, that was a bit.
But what you saw was
it was good.
Then, like, the man just came out swinging. Like, instead of having, you know, five rounds of caution and like tentative
feeding each other out, yeah,
feeding each other out, jabbing. You had man just cut, like every match, man just came out like guns blazing.
I think the closer games would just be way worse. Like the close games, if it's close and they're like going, like I said, it's going back and forth to scoring goals or no one scoring, it will feel way worse.
But yeah, you're saying that you're not thinking about the other side of things where there's the intense side, but there's also the other side where teams are more pragmatic and are not going to go for it. And they're going to, we shouldn't go for this because we're going to save ourselves for the last 5 minutes or last 2 minutes, whatever. Or we're not even going to go for it. We're just going to just chill. Play for a 0-0, and then that's what both teams might do, and you just got the deadest game of your life.
But you could have that now anyway. In fact, you do have that now.
But you still have that with the 30-minute game. It's not always going to be
no. But the thing is, I think the difference is with the 30-minute game. All right, so now say you're an underdog team, right?
Yeah,
and you've got 90 minutes.
There's
a whole 90-minute game that you have to be aware of. You go out. And you've got to, like, say your manager's probably set you up defensively and is like, do you know what, we're playing for the 0-0 draw.
Yeah.
But say you're underdog team and it's a 30-minute game now. We might be like, all right, lads, let's just go out there, nick a goal, and we only have to hold out for 20 minutes.
But they do that. But they could do that anyway.
Yeah, but nicking a goal and holding out for 70 minutes is not the same as nicking a goal.
I feel that takes away from the competition part, because if you're going to then nick a goal in the first 5 minutes and then sit back for the whole time, that's just dead. But whereas at least if you've got a whole 85 minutes to for the other team to come back.
You've got the other team. It's intense because then the other team is just.
But it's not intense. Have you? Banging. Did you watch? I think it was Liverpool West Brom. You probably didn't watch it.
I did not watch.
But
I remember the last time I watched a game.
There's all like these teams. So a lot of teams versus Liverpool.
We're camping in the box,
and it's not fun to watch at all. It's dead. And if that was what every team would do every game, I feel like football would fall.
But they wouldn't do that every game. You have to be able to nick the goal. First of all, you have to be able to nick the goal.
But then if you can't nick it in the first 10 minutes, then you might be like, sit back. Get a 0-0, get a point.
No, because you can still nick a goal.
Yeah, like, on a counter or something.
Yeah, but it's like, I feel like the 30-minute thing gives anyone the opportunity to win. Like, I've seen, I, the last football game I watched, I can't remember, it was Liverpool versus
I don't know if that's a good thing, though.
It gives anyone a chance on the day. That's what sports all about.
But that's what happens now.
No, it doesn't. Because the last game I watched...
As fans going into the situation, it doesn't feel as good if you're going into it with the, like, I feel like it just wouldn't feel as good.
No, because we're thinking about it as fans of big clubs. Like, you go into games, you're an Arsenal fan, you expect to win, you know, against
like 4-0 against Sheffield or something.
Yeah, you're expecting that. Like, but for me, if I was a fan of a smaller club, like, and again, but, and conversely, if you're a fan of a smaller club, you're going in depressed that you're about to get pumped like every weekend.
Okay.
However, if you flip that on its head now, and the games are, and you've got a chance, like, you know that your team's got a chance that they can nick a goal here, there, whatever.
But that's the same now anyway.
I get that. I think that in that situation where it's a 30-minute game and anyone can get a win at any point, the tension comes now on a bigger scale in the actual league standings rather than the individual games, in that, like, near the end of the league where, like, someone who shouldn't be where they are on the standings is, like, right there, and, like, you're a big team thinking, I should be higher.
Yeah.
You're now trying to scrap for wins, like, and then that's when your team is, like, that's when you're the watcher and whatever, the viewer.
And it's mad, because really then you're watching this team's game. Is because it's important.
I get it.
And then what I was going to say is, one of the last football games I watched, I can't remember who, it was a Liverpool game, I can't remember who they were playing. But the other team scored first.
Mm-hmm.
And then Liverpool beat them like 5-1 or something. And I'm just thinking, like that is something, like, if you do a 30-minute game, you can't start slow. Like, you just can't do it. You have to be zoned in from the start.
But you can.
How?
Because you can play for a nil-nil.
In that same situation where, so you're, all right, so you're talking about it from the perspective of teams being defeatist essentially. If you're, yeah. Why would you play for a 0-0? I'm like,
because that's what teams do. Like, you get like West Brom and Sheffield and stuff. They go to Liverpool. They're not expecting to win, so they're gonna go, and if you get a 0-0 there, that's a good result.
Yeah.
Or 1-1. So but you go in.
But my point is that already happens anyway. So yeah. That's not really a difference between the two models.
No, but then on the 30-minute game, then it's just like it gives both teams less chance to score because you've got 30 minutes now. And if I'm still sitting back, I've got now 30 minutes to do my counter-attacking goals, mm-hmm. rather than 90 minutes, which gives me less chance to score then. So it's not necessarily that every manager's going to be like, okay, we're playing Liverpool, we're going to go all out, because that's going to backfire and you're going to concede 4 in the first 10 minutes because you've gone all out against Liverpool.
Yeah, you don't have to go all out, but you got to be like, right, cool, do you know what, yeah. Right.
We can nick a goal in the first 5 minutes. We got this because we've only got 25 minutes to hold the lead. You're going to go all out in the first 5 minutes, and Liverpool are better than you lot. So you're going to concede in those first 5 minutes as well because you've gone all out. You might catch Liverpool off guard for the first 5 minutes or something. Maybe you might nick a goal.
But this is the point.
Yeah.
This is the
point. But that happens now anyway.
But then when you nick a goal within the first 15 minutes or whatever in the 90-minute model, they've now got, you know, 55 minutes or whatever.
But that's fair.
That was bad.
I think that's fair.
Was really bad.
We'll skip over that.
But they've still got, you know, the majority of the games to now turn it around, whatever.
I think that's fair, though.
How's that fair?
Because if you're going to, it's a game of two halves. That's the common saying in football. Mm-hmm. If you go in the first half and you've conceded, you're not able to change it in the first half, you have 45 minutes to then get your match to your manager. Your manager tells you, okay, we need to change tactics. They're sitting deep, try and play it around and cross it in, sort of thing. Mm-hmm. Try and break them down. So you have more chance to then get another goal. Because obviously sitting deep is a crappy tactic. It's a shithouse tactic. It's like, it can get you a win.
It is what it is, man.
It is what it is, yeah. It is what it is, but it's a shithouse tactic. And it's like,
hoof out to Peter Crouch.
You know what I'm saying? It's just Stoke.
Every man sit back and then, yeah, just let hoof out to Peter.
It's a shithouse tactic. And it's like, it gives the teams who are not sitting deep the chance to at least get that goal, to break them down, get the goal. And once they've scored, then that team can't sit deep anymore. They have to come, there's more time for them to then get a second goal and then, or counter-attack and get a second goal. It kind of gives both teams a chance at least. So, well, 30 minutes isn't long enough.
Do you know what I'm thinking? Have you, I don't know if either of you have ever taken the time, but like, have either of you watched a test cricket match?
Nah. They're like 7 hours, aren't they?
They're like multiple days.
Or days or something. Yeah. Yeah, nah.
Nope.
Okay. And I'm guessing neither of you have watched 2020 cricket either.
Nah.
I mean, I would have when I was younger, but
I've seen bits, but I haven't actually watched it.
And this is what I'm kind of thinking the difference would be, right? So test cricket matches last multiple days and it's really conservative. You'll have the batsman, like the ball will come, and if he feels that the ball is dangerous in any way, he's just going to defend it, mm-hmm. because he knows he's got 4 days or however long,
yeah.
to get the runs that he needs or whatever. Whereas 2020 cricket, you only have 20 overs. It's like a couple of hours in the days, whatever. And you'll have batsmen just attacking everything because they know I've only got, you know, 20 overs, which is 6 balls an over. So that's 120 balls. He's like, mm-hmm. I've only got 120 balls and I need to make X amount of runs. So do you know what? I'm going to attack this ball. I'm not going to just, you know, try and hit it and run. I'm going for sixes and fours. I'm trying to smack this every which way. And then I can watch a 2020 cricket match. Like, it can be so much fun.
Mm.
I mean, it's not my favourite thing in the world to do. I'm not definitely not running to it. But if I came in a room and someone was watching 2020 cricket, fine. But test cricket, no way. No, absolutely no way. That's too long, it's too boring. Everyone's being conservative because they've got so much time. Everyone's trying to be tactical and da da da. Like, they're not relying on, you know, their raw skill and ability, whatever. Mm-hmm. They're just trying to think it through and be like, oh, what's the smartest way to do this? That, da, da, da.
Yeah.
And this is kind of what I'm thinking the difference would be in football if you shorten the game.
Yeah.
Is that you would have man just going for the trying to hit the sixes, hit the fours,
because
they've only got a small amount of time.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how I see it in my head anyway. Obviously,
I see where you're coming from.
Yeah.
But I feel like in a 30-minute game, you can't, one team would be going for it and hitting the sixes and one team would have to be conservative and trying to not concede goals. So you're going to get, I don't think both teams can't go for it because you'll lose. And obviously,
Someone would lose.
But let's say you're Liverpool versus Sheffield. Sheffield are not as good as Liverpool. So if Sheffield went for it, Liverpool probably going to more likely to score.
But that's fine. Liverpool, all right. So there's nothing wrong with that. No, if you're saying Liverpool are the better team, then there's absolutely nothing wrong with Liverpool winning the game. I'm not saying Sheffield need to win
but
the game.
But I'm saying they have the chance. You're saying that for Sheffield, they only have, if they score in the first 5 minutes and they have 25 minutes to defend the goal, rather than having 85 minutes to defend the goal, which is then like, if they're going to go for it and concede that first 5 minutes and then have 25 minutes to then what, try and get another goal, or...
They could do, like, my thing is, right, you see in football how they, you know, they have the term of, oh, they were the better team on the day.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, for Sheffield United to beat Liverpool, they need to be the better team on the day for 90 minutes.
Yeah.
In this method, they just have to be the better team for 30 minutes, which for me is way more doable. It doesn't need to be. Why does it need to be long?
Because you need to engage the fans. You need to
30 minutes is a long time.
It's not that long.
30 minutes is a long time.
Right now, half is 45 minutes. So imagine, like,
you have some crazy. You see some crazy halves.
Even a half isn't long enough. Like, because I feel like, yeah, you're better team on the day, and then it's like you watch a half of football, and it's like, okay, second half now. And then when they at the
I feel
time,
like there used to be 60-minute football at Premier League games when we were children.
What, for both halves or?
No, half an hour.
Okay. No, I don't think so.
I mean, I might be making that up, but I feel like there was.
But it would just be like, yeah, I feel like it would be too quick because, like, imagine being a fan and going to a game and you've watched a 30-minute game of football and it's just like, you've got in the stadium, you've gone all that way to go and just watch 30 minutes. And
I mean, that's you're thinking about it in terms of now also, because you're comparing it to now. True. So obviously, now you're expecting 90 minutes.
Yeah.
If you're paying for that ticket, you're expecting 30 minutes.
That's true.
And then also, I think that gives us the opportunity to have multiple games in the same stadium at the same time. Like there's this discussion about whether women's matches should play in the same stadiums as the men.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this would be the opportunity to have, literally just make it the thing, like either the women's matches first or the men's matches first or whatever.
You get
two matches, half an hour each. Women's, you watch the women's game, Arsenal ladies versus Tottenham ladies, then you watch Arsenal versus Tottenham.
Yeah.
The men's afterwards.
But you could do it anyway. And
I mean, you could do
that.
I'd
happily, like, you can happily make a day of it and go watch a couple games of football.
That's quite long though. That is actually quite long.
It is long, but I feel like just watching, like, so if I was to go and watch three games in, so at the same time, you've watched three games in the same amount of time as you would watch one game now. I feel like it's not worth it. I feel like it's not worth watching this. Like, I'd rather watch one game in 90 minutes because I feel like more can happen. And it's just like, it's just more, obviously there's, you get games where it's just very boring for.
But like, all right. So like, you play FIFA, right?
Yeah.
Why don't you play FIFA on 30-minute halves then? Or like,
that's too much. No, but I also, like, when you play football, do you play football 30 minutes or do you play football for an hour or an hour plus?
I play as long as I want.
Exactly.
But I'm not playing competitively.
I don't play FIFA competitively. I play computer.
Okay, cool. Fair enough. But I'm just playing to enjoy myself or whatever, like, just have fun. So obviously I want to have fun for as long as I want to have fun for. Like, sometimes it might be hard. Sometimes I've played football for 5 minutes before. Just, you know them ones you just go to the park and, oh, just give us a touch. Like, then I realised...
I don't count as playing football, bro.
Then I realised, you know, like, I'm getting on in age now. My knees ain't quite what they used to. Be like...
I'm done now, pineapples.
Yeah. Like, quick, 1-2 kick-ups. And then, yeah, no, that's me.
That don't count as football. That's the touch. That one touch.
Gives a touch. But yeah, now sometimes it will be a quick thing. Sometimes it will be longer. Sometimes, like, it will be like the whole day. Like, sometimes, like, when the man them are feeling it, and it's like, you know what? Yeah, let's go goals on this day. And
yeah,
like, I wake up, stretch out.
Oh my
god. have a bath the night before, so I'm feeling loose.
How old are you again?
Oh man, I'm 57.
26 going on 70.
But yeah, so it just varies. But for me, I think, like, the competitiveness of it, I feel like time, like a more restricted time limit is mad. Like, even like, for example, and this is a really like left example, especially for Cam, but like in like wrestling, WWE, and
mm-hmm.
whenever they did like a time limit match,
yeah,
it was just way more intense than other ones.
Yeah.
When it was like, oh, like how many pinfalls or how many like victories can you get?
But then you hated Goldberg, who had 5 minute matches regularly.
But his 5 minute matches were always the same. That was my problem. Like, my problem was not the fact that he had 5 minute matches. My problem was that his 5 minute matches followed the exact same formula. Like, if you saw one of his matches, you'd seen them all.
That's how 30 minute games could go. Because if they're going to all follow the same, if like, obviously, they're all going to just go for it. It's the different players, obviously. So,
but longer different matches could be the same. It could be just like Brock Lesnar matches, which are longer than Goldberg matches, but they're the same as well. Just German suplex, German suplex, German suplex. Like,
but obviously, because I feel like with 90 minutes, you got more time to tactics. You got more time for this. You got more time to plan out how you're going to play the game. Whereas 30 minutes, it's very condensed and kind of obviously 30 minutes. I feel like that gives you 10 minutes to try and get a goal.
Mm.
And if you haven't got that goal in the first 10 minutes, then obviously you have to then decide what you're going to do in the next 10 minutes.
Do you know what I think they should have done with the Super League, right? What they should have done is they should have made it a 5-on-5 tournament.
So like, goals, have so it, like, power league.
So yeah, so like Arsenal can still play in the Premier League with their full squad, but they need to submit like, say,
a 10-man squad or something.
Yeah, 10-man, 7-8-man squad to the Super League. And yeah, five.
Rush goalie.
Yeah, no, literally, rush goalie.
That would be sick, people street style. That would be sick.
Just come and be like, all right, cool, we're going to send Aubameyang.
That would be a good idea. I feel like that would actually be a good idea.
And then, yeah, shorten the games and then just have like this different thing. Yeah, that'd be mad.
If they were going to do that, I would be down for it. Five aside, just have like the top players. So you have like Neymar, Mbappe, whoever else in PSG, the big. So yeah, this would be FIFA Street. Just get the biggest players from each team, because obviously they were also saying they're going to ban players from playing international duty and stuff like that if they play in the Super League. So get a couple of the biggest names, the Aubameyang, Lacazette, just a couple of skillful players, and just that's it. Just get Rabonas in there. That'll be hard.
Slightly smaller pitch, much
smaller pitch.
So 95.
Yeah, you're saving your energy in that as well. Hopefully, just no injuries in that. But yeah,
like a basketball court size pitch.
Yeah,
and just let him go at it.
I think that would be good. I'd be down for that one. That's a good shout. Should submit that on to Fiorentina Perez. He might get involved in that. You know what? You're on something here.
Yeah, man. But mad, we're almost like deep in this, and we've just really been like just chatting, like on random things. We ain't really covered too many other topics and that, but it is what it is. Episode 15. We're here to party and celebrate, really, man. So I think that's what we've been doing. That's it. I feel like we ain't drunk as much as we should have done.
I'm a bit waved, not gonna lie.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Buzzed? You buzzed? No.
Yeah, you might ain't drunk as much as you should have done. I'm a bit waved. Pour up, drink.
Right, so yeah, now let's run another song then. So me and Cam can pour up. And yeah, we'll be back.
22 with a 2.2, just came back from a long hiatus. She came, that came from the clip. No shit, I don't need vibrators. You get hit with a stick, Black Panther, you're gonna need vibranium. I got stainless steel, I got platinum, I got gold and I got titanium. I got gold and I got titanium, I got white gold and it came in proper. Go find you a burner and offer, how you got gold and you ain't got copper. Dosser, Tyson Fury in a party, I make shoulders fling. Clitch go in the ring, cause you just got a box in the Gypsy King. Jeez, same old story, you can get so.
Yes. Out to Dave and that one track and title, Titanium. Yeah, Bez was turning up getting
caught. I'm ready for this, right? I need to get back out. Let me out. Freedom and them.
Yeah, man, Bez was getting hyped to that. I hear that. It's definitely sounding hard from Dave. Right, so yeah, nice. It's our 15th episode. We had this idea that we're going to come in here, going to play a couple drinking games since we've been drinking, and yeah, just make the most of it. So Bez is going to be our master of ceremonies, our MC for the drinking game. So yes, Bez, yes. What we playing, man?
Okay. Talk to us. So the first game we've got here, we've got a 5-second question game. So basically the rules are, it's going to give you questions and you have 5 seconds to answer. So like, ooh, let's say, so it might give you like name three types of fruit. Okay. You got to name three types of fruit in 5 seconds. If you don't,
drink.
Yeah.
Bloody hell, mate. Bloody hell.
So I thought that might be a bit of fun to do. I've got a couple others, but I thought this is a good starter. See how this one goes and then if you aren't on the floor, then we can go and tell some others maybe.
Yeah. I mean, this has already been quite a long podcast, so maybe we'll give it a go for about 20 minutes or so. Let's definitely get into it, man.
The goal is you don't need to be on the floor, though. That's what I'm saying.
I don't know about all that, mate. But
all right, Yells, name three breeds of dog and go.
Chihuahua, Shih Tzu, and Rottweiler.
Did you say Shih Tzu?
I said that's a breed of dog, though.
It's a Shih Tzu.
That's what I said.
I'm gonna give you that one.
What,
sorry,
Shih Tzu, man.
I ain't giving you that one.
All right, I'll drink, but I'm being robbed. But only in the spirit of good vibes, I'll drink in it. But you know what I meant.
I'm not sure I do.
Blah blah blah, Rottweiler.
All right, Cam. Name three places where you wear shorts. Go.
The beach, the swimming pool, and...
Time's up. Oh, Jesus. You're out of here.
On the football pitch. We were just talking about football for ages.
Ah, yes.
Come on, mate.
All right, Yells. This should be easy one for
nah,
you.
Nah, spread it.
What?
You're doing one.
I'm the quiz master.
No. Come.
I put my name in there as well, but I was like,
Sin,
this ain't
Sin.
One for me.
It literally says question for Bez.
Yeah, because I put my name in there, but I was right, like,
and you know what the question is. So, and this is an easy one, to be fair. So, name three musical instruments:
piano, drums, guitar.
All right, cool. Yeah, you do it. You're lucky. You're lucky. You got that. Why is he getting an easy one, though? That one was,
that
so
was easy.
Easy
for you, lot. I had to think about it for a second. I could have got the dogs, I'm sure. Okay, Yells. Name three member states of the European Union. Go.
France, Germany, Italy.
Oof, banged it. He knows his countries then.
That was not hard at all.
He knows his countries.
That would have been, I know what countries I could say, but it would have just rocked same. Me straight.
Same. That's what when I read it, I was like, ooh, because I'm like, this is an easy one when you think about it, but at first you look at it, you're like,
nah, not me.
What?
Not me.
England. UK.
after you've been living through Brexit,
we're in Brexit.
Is that what you think? But yeah, no, that was calm.
All right, Cam. Name three words that start with ho. Go.
What? Holland.
Time's up.
Name three words that start with ho.
H-O. Holly.
No, that I'm. God damn it.
Oh dear.
Okay, that's wild. Right, so Bez. Oh, shame. Okay, so name three units of measurement:
kilometers, meters, millimeters.
Cheeky. We'll allow it, but that's cheeky.
Kilometers, kilograms.
I was going to say kilowatts, and then I was like, kilometers. I'm like, ah, oh, fuck, I'm going to go with meters now.
I see the vision. I see it.
All right, Yells. Name three brands of computer. Go.
Dell, Acer, and Packard Bell.
Nice.
Man's like a classic.
Bell. I know, Packard Bell. I ain't heard the Packard Bell in a long time.
It was just the one that came to my head. Like, I should have said Mac or something. But
yeah, that's what I would have started.
All right, Cam. Name three ways you can get a red card in soccer. Go.
Dirty tackle. Sport, man. Taking off your shirt twice.
That is one. Yeah.
That's what I thought, but it's such a long thing to say.
So it's like dangerous conduct.
Swearing.
Yeah. I didn't even know you could get a red card for that.
You can eventually.
Swearing at who? Just
the I think Rooney got banned for swearing at the cameras when he scored a goal or something. He ran to the camera and was like, fucking come on. And then they gave him a red card or something for it.
Right, Bez. You've had some hard ones.
That one would have thrown me as well, to be fair.
All right, so name three famous animals from a movie.
Tiger, bear, lion.
No.
What do you mean?
Absolutely not. You guys, it wasn't about the animal. It's about
the name
of the character.
I thought, no, you said
Name three famous animals from a movie. You can't just go tiger, bear.
Name three famous animals. They are famous animals, though. That's
from a movie.
Yeah.
So we're talking Scooby-Doo. We're talking...
I didn't know that. I thought it was just the three animals.
Nah, drink up.
That's not fair.
Cam, you agree with me, right?
I've been robbed.
Honestly, I would have said the same thing as him, but I do agree with you.
Okay. Now you've said it, I see what you're saying, but like, when you read the question...
These kind of things.
When you say name three animals, I'm thinking, okay, like...
I didn't say name three animals. I said name three famous animals from a movie.
Yeah, but which is the three animals.
Nah, we're talking character names. So we're talking like the... You could have gone with like the people from Madagascar, if you remember their names.
I don't remember their names.
I don't.
Just like King Julian, that's it. That's
there you go, that's one of them.
But I thought it was just animals. I thought it's the animals.
Herman? I don't know.
I've been robbed. Freaking... All right. Name three kings, yells.
Charles, Henry VIII.
Can't just say Charles.
Is there even a Charles King?
Yeah, there was.
There must be eventually at one point. Yeah,
Charles. Yeah, nah, I fumbled that.
Fumbled that bag. Yeah.
Was he the original Charles though? Was he Charles the
he
first?
He was the Charles. Charles one, I Charles think, two. Charles. You could have fully finessed that. King Henry one, King Henry two, King Henry eight. You could have fully finessed that one.
Wasn't thinking, but yeah.
All right, Cam. Oh my god, you're getting hard ones, you know. Name three famous TV serial killers. Go.
What does that mean though? Like TV as in the show or TV as in they've had Time's documentaries? Up. As like,
TV as in the like show. Dexter. So like Dexter, yeah, would have been one. I just 3XK. 3XK.
My instant was, my brain just went to Ted Bundy straight away because like...
Real life.
Yeah, because...
He's got a TV series, hasn't he? Yeah, documentary. Yeah.
That. I wouldn't have got any more than that. That would have been it.
Nah,
I would have got Dexter and that was it.
I would have said Dexter 3XK and then I would have been fumbling.
Yeah, yeah. I couldn't think of any others. Bates Motel, Norman Bates. That's Norman, but they would have taken me a while to get that one. I wouldn't have even thought
3XK, so
speak. What's 3XK?
He's from Castle.
Oh, okay.
He's been watching Castle as well.
Yeah, but I...
You didn't get the question.
Castle story episodes are the least, well, my least, and the ones I enjoy least.
Oh, you just like the random episodic ones, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough. Right, Bez, man, like, you ready?
No, I'm not.
I don't think so.
Oh, God.
Name three places where you can find stairs.
House, building.
Fumble.
The gym.
Yeah, you're done.
I don't know.
You're done, son. You're done.
House, building, house.
Man said house, building.
It's three places you can find stairs,
was,
you know.
That was good. You should have said the studio. The stairs in.
That's true, you know. But when you're on the spot, you can't think.
It's just the 5 seconds. It's just like, it's too much.
Oh my God. You get easy ones. Name three objects that are blue.
Pepsi bottle.
The sea, the sky.
They're not objects.
I know, I'm joking.
Oh, man. I can't even think of anything else now. Just
a t-shirt.
I mean, yeah, I could have gone with that. Oh my God, that's so bad. All right.
Cam, name three places that have the word island in them. Go.
This is so
that is a fucked one. Man. I can't. Time's up. But I can't even think of one. Virginia Islands, Jersey, Channel Islands.
I'm trying to think of a specific one.
Yeah, that's a hard one.
Yeah,
you're getting all the hard ones. I don't know why.
It's unfair. What the hell's going on?
Oh, Bez, this is an easy one, actually.
Oh, God. Right. You say that and I'm going to fumble it.
I think, yeah, that the alcohol is like starting to touch people. That's why. But name three pizza shops.
Papa John's, Domino's, Pizza Hut.
There you go, easy, easy.
Bring me food, I'm here for this one. I'm here for that, ready for that one.
Easy.
These cups are poor, man. They're starting to melt.
Yeah.
Because they didn't have the proper ones and they only had the small plastic ones. I was like, I'm not sure about them, so I'd get the bigger ones, but they started to melt. Oh my God. You might be a good at this one, actually. Yells, name three mountains, go.
Everest, Kilimanjaro and Snowdon.
Those are the three I would have said. As you said them, I was like, yep.
I wouldn't have got that. My geography is not that good.
Yeah, nah, those, I think, yeah, I tapped out after those three. If there was four I needed to
What's
do.
What's Vesuvius? Volcano, isn't it?
It's a volcano.
Yeah, that's a volcano, okay. Yeah.
Cam. Oh my God. Name three radio hosts. This might be one for you, actually. Three radio hosts.
Hosts, Logan, Sama, Rude Kid, Sparrow.
Sure. I mean, although Logan's not on radio at the moment.
He's been, though.
But he has been.
So are we taking it then?
We'll allow it.
Okay, we'll allow it.
He's had some difficult ones.
Yeah, that's another. I would have got none.
I just went for the grand DJ.
I had to. I don't know who else I could have said.
Could have said Yells.
Who's that?
the disrespect in the room right now.
Honestly, like when he said hosts, I thought of people who are not like DJs, more like talk host people.
Mm.
And so that's why I was like, am I going to go there? And I was like, let me just list off some DJs.
Yeah,
I would have got none.
The disrespect, you would have got none. Yeah?
I wouldn't have said. I would.
The absolute.
My would have gone, mate. My would have gone. Head would have gone. Tiffany Calver, is she a radio host?
She's a radio host.
Okay, I would have got one.
I said Logan first, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
yeah. So I went to Logan because I know that he like talked quite a bit on his show, and then I went to Spyro second because I was like, Spyro, I have to shout out to Dolly. I just said Rukit because I was like, I know he has his freaking radio show.
Cam, you're digging a hole, you know?
I'm like, not digging a hole.
I said Spyro because he has shouted Don, but.
As far as I'm concerned, you shouldn't expect your name to come up. Not because of like, no disrespect, but like, literally no disrespect.
Podcast cancelled, bro.
Do you know what? I'm not even going to respond to that. All I'm going to say is every other Sunday, Mode London yells 9 to 11 p.m. Come check me out, man. We have a good time.
Big things.
Clearly, Cam and Bez don't listen. But Cam and Bez, that we discussed earlier in the podcast, are nerds. So if you're not a nerd, come listen to me.
Raw, you're just going to just cut all the nerds, yeah? All right, cool. All right.
Bro, it is what it is.
You're a nerd too, so like...
I retweet and like all your shit, man. I'm here for you.
I don't know about all.
When I see it, I do.
Nah, I appreciate it. Right, Bez. Name three activities that are forbidden in public.
Peeing, naked, nudity, head. I don't know why that came to me in the last time. I don't know.
I'm finished.
I'm sure that's not allowed in public.
I'm finished. That's jokes. This is the way he was like, heads.
We'll
give it to you.
Even the nakedness, I like nudity, because I thought you were going to be like, nakedness, that's the right word.
It's not really an activity per se, but oh, yeah, do you know what? Do you know what? We're being flexible.
Act of being nude.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Thank you, Cam. Respect, brother.
Get out of my pub, mate.
All right, Yells. Oh, good luck, mate. Name three brands of makeup.
Maybelline Light, Maybelline Dark.
Is that a thing? I'm not taking it. No. I'm not having that one. No. You did well, Maybelline. I was thinking MAC. That was the only one I had.
Maybelline. Maybe it's Maybelline.
You could have said Fenty.
Oh, well.
Yeah, Maybelline, MAC, and Fenty. You got your three there.
Between the three of us, we got it.
All right, Cam. Name three things you do in a car.
Drive, listen to music. Oh no.
Time's up.
Oh no.
What else?
Oh no.
Dogging.
Yeah, no, car sex.
What else? Drink. Eat.
Not while you're driving.
Oh, Bez. Right. You should be able to get this one, to be fair.
No,
you should, but it's just whether you'll get it in 5 seconds or not. I mean, that's more to the point. But name three politicians that are currently active.
Boris Johnson, Matt Hancock, and Sadiq Khan.
Yeah.
Whew.
Got it. Oh, no.
Oh, my God. Yells, name three famous men with moustaches.
Who's got a mustache? Bloody hell.
Bajo always be like, Yells, Bears, Cam. Freddie Mercury as anyone I can think of it. And
but does it count? We've all got like full beards.
Yeah, we got Hulk, we got beards.
Huh?
Hulk Hogan.
Nah, fuck the Hulk Hogan.
Coming for you.
Yeah, we don't. Mad, yeah, nah. Fumbled.
I can think of characters, but I can't think of the names of the actors.
I think about the Superman brother that, because obviously.
Henry Cavill.
But I can't remember his name.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you can remember characters, but the name of the person who plays the character.
Freddie Mercury is anyone I can think of. I can't think of anyone else.
Who's the guy from Lemmy from Motorhead, but he's obviously passed away.
Yeah.
But he had, like, the handlebars and that.
Yeah. Thing. All right, Cam. Name three things that you can climb.
A ladder, stairs, a wall.
Sure.
Yep.
You made a meal out of that, but yeah.
A wall.
I get two out and then I'm like, God for the third.
Why does Bez get the easy ones?
You say that and I'm end up flopping it because you say that and then you just put me on the spot now.
I get the hard ones.
you haven't had a hard one in a minute, but Bez has, this is ridiculous. Name 3 months in a year.
March, January, February. Love it. Love
why
it.
Why did you say it in that order?
I don't know why I said in that order. I was going to go March, January, February. April, May, and I couldn't think of what was after March. I'm back.
That's outrageous.
I was trying to March. I'm like, shit, what's after March? Okay, January, February. Oh, this is an easy one. Name 3 countries in South America.
Brazil, Argentina, Ecuador.
Yes, easy. Easy.
I almost thought you were asking him as well. Like, you need to say my name first.
Okay, sorry.
I wasn't going to say anything. I was like, oh, snap. This is me.
Sorry. All right, I'll say names. Cam, name 3 meals that have fish in them.
I hate this.
That's a hard one. That is a hard one. I can't think of any. Sushi, that's it. That's not really a meal, is it?
Well, no, it counts.
Yeah.
You can say sushi, fish and chips, chowder. Seafood chowder. I don't know.
I just went saltfish and I was like,
Aki and saltfish. Yeah, Aki and saltfish.
I didn't think Aki and saltfish. My brain just said saltfish and I was
saltfish
like,
saltfish patty.
That's just saltfish. Like, I can't just
tuna sandwich.
Well, there you go. Aki and saltfish, fish and chips is a tuna sandwich.
My brain said saltfish and then I was like, I
don't know what goes with it.
Bez, name 3 brands of TV.
Sony, Samsung, Hitachi.
Okay, fair enough. Again, easy.
I wasn't sure about that one for a second. I was like, what brands are the TV? Like, what are you asking?
Hitachi.
Man looked at the question there. She little chief. Name 3 ways to become a millionaire. Go.
Footballer, entrepreneur, basketball player.
Yeah, man. Easy.
Easy. Light work.
Dogecoin.
Dogecoin. That should have been it. Dogecoin, Bitcoin.
Oh my God. Cam, name 3 boy bands.
NSYNC, Backstreet Boys.
Backstreet.
Time up.
Busted, man. Wait, what? Said I've been to the year.
Harry Styles Boys.
One Direction.
Ah, Jesus. I couldn't remember the name.
Not much has changed, but I live on the water.
Wait, what did you say? Great.
Busted.
See, I know that song, but I don't know the name of the band.
It's Busted.
Busted.
Yeah.
Well, who's the ones that sing Stacey's mom has got it going on?
I don't know. Say that one. I would have got Busted and Blue, and that's probably like Blue's the one for the money and the
three This, I don't know. I don't know if you'll get this one. I can't lie. You would if you had more time, but 5 seconds is a techie.
Oh, God.
Name 3 Tom Hanks movies.
Toy Story 1, Toy Story 2, Toy Story 3.
You arsehole. You
really
arsehole.
Went there. Jesus.
The funny thing is, I had more in my head. I was like, Castaway, Philadelphia. I was thinking of, then I'm like, Toy Story 1. Oh, Toy Story 2, 3. Easy.
That is a fairly easy one, though. Even without the Toy Stories, that is a fairly easy one.
Yeah.
But 5 seconds. I thought 5 seconds would be... It is. I get it. Like, you could name 3 Tom Hanks movies. It's quite easy.
I don't know what my third one would have been, but I would have said Castaway, Big, and then I don't know what the third one would be.
Yeah, I
would have
said Castaway, Toy Story, and Philadelphia. But then when I said Toy Story, I was like, oh, Toy Story 1, 2, 3. It's easy.
Bloody outrageous, mate.
Stop looking at the question.
I didn't look at the question.
I thought you were as well because you were clicking up.
I was exiting out of the advert because it's free games and there's adverts on there.
All right. Yells. Name three household chores. Go.
Cleaning the bathroom, washing the dishes, and cleaning the cooker.
Easy. Do you do all of those, yeah?
Yeah, I'm domestic. Mad domestic.
Do all of those.
Mad domestic.
Keeping the house tidy.
I am. So ladies, if you want someone to clean your house, don't come for me. That's not going to happen. Can't lie.
Cam, you're not getting this one.
This is so fun.
This is not fair for you at all. Name three soccer stadiums.
Oh, Emirates. Oh, crap. No.
Terrible.
Old Trafford. And then the one that Barcelona plays
in. Oh, you nearly got it. I was surprised.
I went.
Terrible. Shocking.
I should get that. I should be able to.
I don't think you would. Because I didn't know.
Old Trafford and then
Wembley.
The New Camp. Wembley.
New Camp is what I was trying to get.
Yeah. Craven Cottage. You've been to, like, even the word, you've been to more than three stadiums.
I've been to New Camp. I've been to
Craven Cottage.
I don't know where
we watched. Fulham, and we watched the game there.
Yeah, no, but also, who cares? Outside of going there, Fulham fans, know,
turn away
what,
now
I
before
what it's named.
Yeah,
and then
you,
I've been to Wembley also.
Yeah,
and then obviously Emirates.
I think I wouldn't even got that in 5 seconds. I would have been like Emirates.
You definitely would have
in 5 seconds. It's one of the ones where it just throws you off.
Emirates, Anfield, like
I know I can list them for days.
You so quickly.
I don't know.
What's the Milan one?
The what one?
Milan.
San Siro.
Yeah.
Yeah. I should have got. Yeah. I definitely could have got that.
Right, Bez. You ready?
Yo. Let's go.
Name three things you need for a vacation.
Passport, travel money, and suitcase.
He's killing this game. He's killing the game.
I'm ready.
Oh, no.
Turn it. All right. Yells. My God. Name three famous ships.
Titanic. Some famous ships.
I wouldn't have got that at all.
You know.
Famous. What's famous? What?
Titanic.
Christopher Columbus is one. What's that? The Black Pearl.
Windrush is one. Titanic, Windrush, and yeah, five seconds is not enough.
That's a tough one, that one.
All right, let me take a drink then. Let me just take a sip.
Oh, I can't. This is an easy one for you then. Name three famous female singers. Go.
Rihanna, Beyonce, Kelly Rowland.
Sure.
You said that very slowly. Like, I was like, are you going to say it in 5 seconds?
Because I keep knowing two things, and then the third one just takes a little second for me to get it. So I wanted to give myself time. If I say it too fast, then I'll just be there like,
I hear you, All right, Bez, name three objects that start with the letter B.
Banana, bed. Oh, I don't know.
You better drink, Maggi.
Ball.
That was the first thing that came to my head. Was ball.
Shot.
Bez wins. The other sucked very badly. Bez has won.
How?
Did I?
Because I pressed the wrong button, even though.
Oh, you. Yeah.
Alright, we'll play.
Yeah, I was dying the rest of your drink because you fumbled it.
Nah, we're playing again. Do we still have time? We still have time.
All right then. All right, Yells. Name three objects that start with the letter G. Go.
Golf ball. Grape. And.
Time's up.
Flipping out.
5 seconds is not a long time. That's all you think of.
And grapefruit.
I should have said Grey Goose ball.
Grey Goose. Hey. Bow up. Drink.
Yeah, so Ben's over here drinking Grey Goose like a bad bitch.
I need to get that the new Copperberg flavored one.
Butters.
What do you mean butters? That looks banging, bro. Passion fruit flavored vodka. That's gonna slap. Cam, name three words that rhyme with end.
Bend, mend, send.
Easy.
Once I said the first one, I was there. I was like, wait. And I said the first one, I was like,
man was ready to freestyle. I mean, ends with my bends. Yeah, you got it right.
Tick.
Wait, did I get it wrong?
You got it wrong.
Oh, shit.
You didn't say, you only said two. You said grape and golf ball.
All right. Oh, here we go again. Name three Matt Damon movies.
Oh, I don't know. Any. Brokeback Mountain, Mars, and... Dogma.
The time is up. Do you know what I would have said?
Born Supremacy, Born Automate, and Born
Oh,
Identity.
Yeah, of course.
He was only the exact same thing as
that's
you.
That's why I was assuming you were going to
I couldn't think. I forgot about Born completely.
Identity, Born Supremacy, Born Automate.
The thing is, I wouldn't have got all that. I would have got the Born Identity, and that I wouldn't have got any other ones because I can't remember what they're called. I know that thing was in one.
I don't remember Identity, but I remember Supremacy and Automate.
And Matt, what's the other guy? Matt Renner, or whatever his name is. Hawkeye.
Yeah.
He was in one of them as well, so I would probably end up sending that one or something. So
that was just like Born, isn't it?
It might have been just Born, yeah.
Something like that. But yeah, or I would have said that The Martian.
No, it was Mars. Was it The Martian, wasn't it? Oh, I said Mars. There was Martian.
Said,
yeah.
You could have said Thor Ragnarok.
Is he in that? Oh, he's in
he's
that like
thingy,
second,
isn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah,
he's playing Loki.
Oh yeah, of course.
I forgot about that. That's so funny.
Yells, name three types of flowers.
Roses, sunflower, and tulips.
Oh, I'll give you it. It was close. I'll give you it.
I was thinking of what's the other one?
Lily.
Not lilies.
Dandelions.
Nah. Do you know, like, obviously ones that you get in bunches as well. Is that there's two types of like popular flowers. It's roses and
it's lilies or tulips.
Tulips.
Tulips are the other like popular ones.
Is that what I said?
You said tulips, yeah.
Okay, maybe I got there in the end then. Fair enough.
All right, Cam.
You said sunflower.
Yeah, in the middle. Sunflower.
Name three famous battles. Go.
Water roses. I don't know.
I wouldn't have got that one, bro. Battle of the Bridges or something. It must be one or something.
You man don't know,
like,
your history.
I got one though, right? Water roses.
That's a big one.
World War One, World War Two.
Battle of Waterloo, Battle of Trafalgar Square.
The first thing that came to my mind was just American Civil War, but I don't know what the famous battle for that would be.
Yeah, I don't know that either. But you know, don't you know your Dundalk?
No. I literally hate history so much.
History was like, it was a nightmare.
Okay, then. This is really weird. Name three events that made you cry.
When I fell over when I was a baby, when I was born, and Putin.
What?
I was constipated when I was younger, innit? So Putin might have hurt.
Really not to speak. In fact,
we'll give it to you, but I'm not saying final episode of Angel Beats. I'm not saying any more on the subject.
I could not. That is a tough one.
Said being born.
Name three objects that start with the letter T. Yells, go.
A table, a tap, and a tap dancer. Tap shoes.
That was too late?
Yeah, that was too late. Tap shoes were too late. Tap dancer is not an object.
That's an object. People are objects.
Wow. I don't think you can say that.
You are screwing.
Cam, name three types of office supplies. Go.
Pencils, pens, rulers.
Smashed it. Easy.
I mean, do people use rulers in office?
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know about that.
I do.
Yeah.
Do you?
Yeah.
To do what?
To underline stuff.
Were you underlining in an office?
Okay. So when I'm doing accounting stuff, I need to underline things so I can write the bills next to them. And obviously with the time, with the amounts that are there, it makes it easier to bill how that much. So you kind of just underline it all, keep it all rounded off.
I mean, I've never used a ruler in office.
That's funny because in my office, I buy all the stationery.
And you never bought rulers?
I never bought a ruler.
I shouldn't have given that to you then, but I use rulers in office, so I'd give. That's what
so
I'd give.
I was right.
Yeah, I'd give it to you.
So leave me alone.
I don't know. I wouldn't have given it to you. I'm just letting the record show that I would not. Rulers is a school thing.
He literally said that he uses rulers.
I use them
in the office.
Okay, no, but I use like my phone in the office, not office stationery.
Office
is stationary. I mean, the ruler is stationary, and then it's in the office that I use it.
Can I buy a ruler from Office Depot? Probably.
Can you buy 100%. Phone? You can buy a phone from Office Depot. You can buy so much from Office Depot, my guy.
Yeah,
that's Ryman's. I think you can buy you can't buy a phone from Ryman's, could you?
You can buy you can buy tea and coffee from Ryman's, my guy. You lot are having this argument with the wrong person. I use these websites on a daily. Like, you can buy so much from these websites that has nothing to do that. It's not office related. It's not stationery related.
I feel like, but you keep ruler in a pencil case. You keep ruler in a pencil case. That's like
pencil case is a school thing.
Yeah, but that's like stationary stuff you keep in there. So that means ruler is stationary.
It's office stationary, not school stationary.
But it's stationary, and then you can buy it on the route on the office sites. So which means it's office stationary.
That's not how it
works. If it's stationary and you use it in office, then it's office stationary.
But you don't use it in office.
He uses it in office.
That's just him.
No, but the fact it's in the office means that other people use it as well.
That doesn't mean anything. There's loads of stuff in the office that people don't use.
Why would it be there then? They wouldn't have bought it if it's unnecessary.
If it's in the office, even if people don't use it, it's office stationary.
It's not. It's not, because office stationery is stuff that everyone uses. So when you said pens, pencils, or whatever you said, like pads, like that sort of stuff, scissors, like, yeah, okay, cool. Everyone uses these things. Highlighter pens, like everyone uses these things.
I've never used a highlighter pen in my life. Not even at school. I'm joking, I use it at school, but not in the office.
There's it in the office as well, yeah. I need them in the office.
Loads
as well.
Of people use those in the office. Like rulers though, like, I'm just saying, no one needs to draw a straight line in your office. Like, just generally, like, people...
If you work for an accounting firm, architecture firm, then you're going to use a ruler.
All types of rulers and protractors and...
Exactly. So then does a compass become office stationery? Because, no. Yes. No, it's an architecture stationery at that point then. So
do architects work in office?
They can.
And this is the thing. I would submit that.
They can.
Of course they can, but like...
In general, do they?
Yeah. Is that the way it works? I swear they work in like they work in design studio kind of.
No,
kind
of. Not Ted like, works in an office.
Ted works from his living room, man.
Ted's a waste of money.
He works in the office.
Whatever Ted does, we don't need to talk about that. Ted's a loser.
But anyway, Bez, name three types of wildcats.
Bobcat, I can't name any others.
Was shocking, my guy.
Lion, tiger, question mark?
Lion, tiger, leopard, lion, tiger, cheetah, lion, tiger.
Honestly, Bobcat was where my mind went first because you said wildcat.
I didn't think of the big cats.
No, obviously, I would have said lion, tiger afterwards.
Yeah.
Bobcat was my first.
I didn't think of that ocelot. Like, you know,
I don't know why, but Bobcat was like the cat that I knew the most in high school, really? Also. I don't know what happened, but there was like some kind of project we had to do and I did it on a Bobcat. So I just remember Bobcats forever.
Yeah, I didn't think about the lions and tigers and all that. I didn't completely didn't think about it.
That's wild.
Literally. All right, yells. After what we've been talking about, name three things you buy for school. Go.
Ruler, pencil, and a compass. Why not?
Very convenient, eh? Very convenient. Cam, name three websites. Go.
YouTube, Amazon, Twitch. Twitch.
Sounds like you're struggling.
Twitch. I mean, I want to keep it.
All right, Bez. Name three clothing stores.
Nike, Adidas, and Uniqlo.
Okay.
Adidas.
Man went for the brands, but I hear it.
That's what the stores are called.
Yeah, I know.
Adidas.
Primark. Primarni.
Adidas.
Yells, name three types of hot beverages.
Tea, coffee, and...
Time's up.
Good. He doesn't drink them. I don't drink them either,
but hot chocolate, bro. I thought that would have been the first one you went for.
I don't drink it. I do not consume.
Neither do I, but as a person who doesn't drink it, hot chocolate is always the one that, because obviously it's the sweetest one. It's the first one that you'd go to.
For me, just, nah.
Hot drinks in general are just...
I don't drink them. I don't think about them. But then also, in terms of people around me and stuff, it's always tea and coffee.
It's always coffee. Like, I get that.
So, yeah.
I drink hot chocolate.
Okay, that's good for you.
And you want me to name you for radio show hosts?
I don't know what to tell you, mate. I don't know what to tell you.
Me, I was getting catty on the Fabulous podcast. Oh, well, after, I love this one. Name three people you wouldn't want to ride in an elevator with. Go, Cam.
The Hulk. She-Hulk. Thanos.
I thought you were going to say yo. After all, just talking.
I'll beat him up. Knock him out. Hey, you are dreaming. Dreaming, mate. Dreaming.
Closed place where no one can protect you.
To be fair, none of those people are people. I don't know why we gave it to him. They're all
fantasy, that's true. Exactly. But they're people in fantasy
they're
world.
They're not even people in fantasy world.
They're not people. What do you mean?
No, Bruce Banner is a person. The Hulk is not a person.
He's a person.
What is he? He's an animal. He's a monster.
He's a mutant. Human.
He's a mutant. That, I shouldn't have given you that one. That's true. They're mutants. They're all mutants.
Thanos
they're
definitely
if you
not.
Thanos
is
an alien. One, it would be Thanos, okay?
Thanos is an alien.
You can't take She-Hulk and Hulk away because they're
mutants.
They are both humans. They are human, mutated humans.
In that form,
they're mutated forms
aren't
thingy.
They're not people. There's no way you can call them people in that form.
That's true.
What do we call them then?
Mutants.
Hulking beasts.
Hulking beast.
Alright, Bez. Name three potato chip flavours.
Ready, salted, salt and vinegar, cheese and onion.
Man had like 3 seconds spare.
The basic ones, man. I had to go for it. I was like, ready, salted? Oh yeah, I got all the basics. Basic. Alright. Yells. Oh wow. You ain't getting this. You might know. You know your stuff. Name three German politicians. Go. Okay.
Angela Merkel.
Angela Merkel.
Yeah, no, that's a myth. That was definitely not gonna happen.
Adolf Hitler.
To be fair, if it was that past or present, then
it just says name three German politicians. So
then, yeah, I could have done Hitler, Goebbels, like them, man.
That's a mad one. That I wouldn't have got that one. My mum said Angela Merkel. Oh wow. Cam, name three songs by U2. Go.
That's not happening.
Yeah, I don't know one song by U2.
I knew one. I can't remember off the top of my head now though, but there was one that I actually, what is it? Oh, I'm never gonna remember it.
Are they the ones that sing "It's a Beautiful Day"?
Isn't that Robbie Williams? No, it's not Robbie Williams, is it?
I don't know.
I couldn't tell you.
Yes, man.
I feel like it's them, but I could be way off. Right, Bez. Jeez. Name three things that you buy in parts.
Car parts, rocket parts, and ship parts.
One time was up, two, that was not the question that we were asking you.
Did you say parts?
Yeah, name three things that you buy in parts. It's not about car parts, it's about like something
the
that
individual
you buy
part.
And you build together. So like IKEA furniture.
I mean, no, but car like car parts and rocket parts.
You don't build the car.
I mean like figurines. You buy
you
a pack.
Mean like figurines.
That's when I said rocket part and ship parts, because you build, you buy the
you
pack of them.
You weren't thinking about figurines.
That's why I said ship and rocket.
What's going on, people? Bez here from the Five Letters Podcast. Unfortunately, the episode got cut off because we kind of ran out of time. But basically what happened was, Yells won that game, last game of 5 second drinking game. Yells won that one. We had a big debate on whether centre forward, I guess the debate continued on whether centre forward or false nine is the position, even though we didn't give them the point, but that continued. And then, yeah, we just continued that game going, got a bit wavy. Yeah, Yells won that one. So hope you all had a good bank holiday weekend. Remember to follow us on the Five Letters Podcast. That's number five Letters Podcast on Instagram, on Twitter. Keep rocking with us, man. We're 15 episodes in. We enjoy recording it. We hope you're enjoying listening. Don't forget to check us out. And again, Five Letters Podcast, number five Letters Podcast. Peace.
of a young messiah. I see sinners in a church, I see sinners in a church. Sometimes I might be introvert, there's a war inside.